Hello, everyone, and welcome to Arcane Focus. I'm your DM, Mike. Joined with me are my amazing players. We have Amber, Steve.
If he dies,
he dies. And Temple.
Hello.
Welcome, everyone, to episode 66 of Magic and Mostead, our ongoing campaign that we've been going on for about 2 years now. Our party is now level 13?
See, something like that.
Something like that. We're really high up there. They've dealt with secret organizations, liches, dragons, giants, and the Fey realm. Honestly, it's getting a little insane. But first and foremost, a couple announcements for you guys, my social media manager can help me out here. We'll be streaming next Saturday. Good, thank you.
Nailed it.
Thank you.
I didn't give you a note otherwise. That's how you know you're fine.
I think we're going to continue on for the rest of July, and then we're going to be kind of rocky. We are still obviously respecting.
Yeah, this kid is giving
August is to be determined.
August is
giving
to be determined.
Me two warnings already that I didn't like, so I was like, okay.
This is the funny part. We might end, or at least take a sabbatical on episode 69.
Which Mike thought was hilarious. Because he's hilarious. Five.
Aren't we all?
Yeah, but like this has been the running joke that we never make it to the milestone, whether it ends in a 5 or a
69
0.
Is the milestone.
So that's why I was just like, damn, man, we're making that true to the T. I mean, hopefully we get to at least episode 70.
So is 69 the one in the July 31st? I think that's the date.
Yes, so.
No, 30th.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I mean, like in general, like it's always like we have something to do, you guys have something to do, something came up. But like it's always that like we have to wait a week and then we eventually get to the 5
so
or the.
My brain want to push it to the 70, but redacted reasons, I don't think we're going to do it. So
we'll definitely wait
we'll
and see.
See.
It's all going to be at ears. I think that is the biggest announcement happening. This week, I'm actually going to be working on merch. We were able to work with Titan Fish Killer, by the way. Thank you so much, Titan.
Yay!
Thank you, Titan.
We have some. We can actually play some of these images that were created of our characters and put them on shirts and cups and things like that. So that's going to be my weekend work, which will be pretty nice. But other than that, not a lot of announcements for you guys.
I created an acronym for Savannah.
Oh.
Because we always said she was the fuck around, find out. So it's F-A-F-O, like member of our group. So I was like, because this is a perfect scenario where we fucked around and now we're finding out.
Well, speaking of fuck around and finding out, you guys ready to find out what happened last week? Let's do a quick recap.
Well done.
A somber moment takes our party as they are standing in the first floor of the Books and Brew. Its emptiness is broken by the sound of coffee being made and silverware being checked. Mary Kane joins the team as they discuss what happened to the employees of the bar and what might have happened a few nights ago. They take a much-needed rest as the morning arrives. Our band is visited by Daryl, one of the royal guards and overseer of the crime scene evidence. With the additional help of Igno the Wise, who arrived in the Books and Brew via an approved teleportation spell, the bodies began to look over the everyone within the room started to look over the numerous evidence that was left behind with the body of Maritumbin when she was taken down. There was the stein, the knife, the nose of a shutdown, black cloth, and more importantly, a strange elixir within a glass vial. Wanting to learn more, the party was led into Meryl Templeman's room, where they found a package where the vial arrived in. Its return address, the Cauldron and Claw. Making their way there, they found that, making their way to the exclusive and illustrious alchemy library and testing grounds. The party met Butterfly, a white-furred tabaxi leader of the Cauldron Claw, and Moth, aka Dallas Killian. A fellow student of Moscow's, and though through some tough questioning and some sleight of hand, the party learned that Killian was being blackmailed to make the very same elixir that was sent to Meryl Templeman. He doesn't know where the blackmailers are, only that they've been sending him threatening letters, all seeming to originate from the main Alrak post office. Before leaving Killian to follow the next lead, Vera placed a death ward on him, only to learn that she prevented his death as moments as the door closed behind them, Killian was nearly killed by a sigil spell. Taking him along with them, the party headed down to the post office. There, Rolly played distraction and kept the colorful employees of the post office busy, while Vera and Savannah snuck around the building. Savannah rushed ahead, finding an illusionary wall in a secret back room slash warehouse. Within it, she overheard the familiar voice of Oliver Blake, just as he slips into a meditative scrying spell. His eyes shot up, learning that we now learn that Ollie was actually scrying on the party that very moment, learning that they were there at the post office. His eyes open, looks directly at Savannah, points in her direction, and motions towards the other Genesis members to burn the trailer down quickly, and stands, looking at the snooping Savannah. So, this is how we're going to handle a few things. First and foremost, Savannah, you are essentially being looked at right now as Ollie has currently jumped out of his scrying spell meditative state, sort of looked up, points at your general direction, sees your sort of cat ears poking out of the window, out of the trailer, and your bright yellow eyes looking at him. I will allow you to do either have an action or a bonus action. Right now, that's the only amount of time you have. You can use your action to dash, but you only have an action or a bonus action.
So I thought about this, and now I realize what I can do, and I don't know what else to do about the situation. Can I use the disc? That's two message spells and invisibility.
Holy shit. The black orb?
Yeah.
That currently holds a spell? Yeah, you can use your action to crash it into the ground.
Send one to Daryl.
I was going to send it to you and Rolly, telling you to get your asses back here.
Well, I'm just saying because they can bring guards.
Damn it, Amber.
I'm just saying because they need evidence to clear evidence.
Well, hold on. So
I'm not there. That's
no, you're
all you.
There. So Savannah, I want you to go by your instinct here. You grab the orb, pull it out of your pack, throw it onto the ground. The orb, and you see two wisps of blue arcane energy, and you are surrounded by this this arcane energy that you've never really had access before. This amount of spells that you've seen Vera use numerous times, but it's almost like an awakening, something you've never tasted before. Is it? And immediately it's released. It's about to release from your hand from both ends. You get to choose two people to send messages to, or you can send the same. Send the one person, and it'll send double the amount of words.
Okay, so Daryl's the smart answer, but I'm going with Savannah's panic answer. It's going to be Vera and Rolly.
Sounds good. First one. You want to? If you could say the same words to both, or if you want
to
say
they're going
separate,
to be the same words to both.
The spell splits like a meta magic twin spell. What do you say? 25 words.
We've been spotted, back room now. Oliver Blake is here. Hurry. 10 more words. I'm in danger.
The last part checks. So I'm like, we knew that from the first part.
You don't have to go.
Oh, like,
I'm in danger.
Vera Rolly. Immediately, you get a message spell from Savannah. The way the spell works is that since you already know Savannah, you're well aware of her, the spell lets you know that this is her casting it.
Okay.
Strange, and you can respond to the messages.
I just say I'm on my way, but can I have, like, an
Not
action?
Yet. Not yet.
No? Okay.
Hold on to your actions. Right now, you can respond via telepathic link via the spell. But I'm going to put you guys in initiative in just a bit.
Okay.
Rolly, any response?
Rolly smash! And I literally say this out loud.
What do you say?
Rolly smash.
Okay. We'll see what the rest of the people say. Savannah, also a brightly pink... a wisp of arcane energy hits the ground, and you are now concentrating on an invisibility spell as your body dissipates and disappears. Let's go ahead and change a thing here. So, the Genesis members immediately reach over. You can actually, Savannah, you're still looking over even in your invisibility state. Is that you can see the two Genesis members that are sitting within the trailer look in the direction where Oliver is pointing. You're no longer there, but they got the command to burn everything.
Bonus action hide.
Bonus action hide. Roll with the advantage.
Yay for advantage. Yes. Ooh, nat 20.
Nat 20. You duck down quick. And I will say the camera, the way the camera sees it. All right, well, then if you're not looking at it, the last thing you see is them turning towards the direction you were, and you've ducked out. Immediately, you can hear the trailer and the wagon start to rock a little bit. You can hear footsteps and yelling from the two members, and then you hear smash. Not knowing what that is yet, you hear as footsteps start to race towards the door of the trailer, as the door opens upwards, and from your vantage point, hiding within the shadow of the trailer, you can see a singular hand push out, and Oliver sort of looks around to see if he could find you. I'm not going to be able to find you, but he's going to use his action to try to look, because that's what would happen. Yeah, he sticks his head out, and he steps out about 5 feet into the room, and you're about maybe 20 feet away from him right now, and he's just standing, and then he starts to make his way towards the door. Now, since we've gone one round with everyone here, I would like everyone to roll me initiative.
Ooh. Of course it would be a natural 20 on that, then sure. Natural
20. Hey, don't
17.
Okay, so natural 20, 17 for Rolly.
18.
18 for Savannah. Vera, with your natural 20, is there any bonuses to it?
Nope. Wait, I don't think so. Nope.
Alright, so
that involves 20. My dex. I'm not a dexterous person.
Good point.
Maybe plus your initiative bonus.
It goes based off your dex. I have a plus zero okay. dex.
Well, you guys rolled very, very high. So we're going to go in order. Vera, you're first.
Is it a free action to tell fucking Killian something?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to tell him that the reason behind his blackmail is in there, and he can either help us and maybe redeem his name, or he can hide. Two, I'm gonna
hide.
Send a message to fucking Daryl.
You use your action to do the sending spell.
Yeah.
Dallas looks at you as you currently go into a quick 1 second meditative state, sending out the spell, and he goes, "Fuck this," and turns around and starts to run.
I'm gonna put, don't think I can't find you, so I wouldn't go too far. Anyway, I'm gonna send a message to him. I'm gonna tell him, let Ruby, I don't know how many, you're gonna have to count.
Okay, got it.
Let Ruby know the Blakes are here. Oliver Blake is hiding in the post office.
Yeah, 10 more.
We need backup before they destroy everything.
Destroy everything. But you're good. You got only one word.
Hurry.
Okay.
Nailed it.
And then I can still use my movement, though, right?
Yeah, you have a turn. So, but Dallas, you immediately get a response from Dallas. All right. I'll send word right away.
You mean Daryl.
Daryl. What is it,
Dallas? You said Dallas.
I have a D-A-R. Sorry.
I was like, why is he responding? I don't know how far I am because of the map is Theater of the Mind. So, yes. How far can I get? with...
It won't it's going to take a lot longer than 30 feet to get into... Well, no. Going around. I'll say about 30 feet in, you're standing right where the carriages are. So let me go and give a reminder to our players of what you're looking at. Or at least Rivera. You're on the side of the building, looking around the corner past these gates.
Yeah.
Towards what looks to be like a lifted gate front where a lot of the carriages for deliveries are.
Mm-hmm.
You curve around the corner. You can hear as your metallic feet and boots hit the ground as you currently skid right inside into the actual post office. There is boxes and paper and you know, there's two carriages with numerous horses and hay and water at the ready, but that's your movement. You currently do not see like Savannah anywhere, but you do see a door that's been opened to a closet.
It's a bonus action to take a potion, right?
It is a bonus action to take a potion.
Would I have to count this as part of my movement? I think I get extra movement, but
do
I don't know.
Do you have this potion of speed?
The flight. Because it says flight.
Oh, no.
It counts as part of my movement?
That counts as part of your movement.
I'll take the potion, though, because it's up for 10 minutes and we're in initiative.
You drink the potion. I think this is the first time you've done the flight potion as...
No, I've taken it before when we were going to die in the volcano.
Okay. something like... It tastes a lot like a diet sangria. It's not the best, but you can feel...
Talk about Moscow, about that upgrade.
Yeah. And immediately you can feel like the weight around your armor starts to lift and, like, starts to lift and start to lighten as you start to hover a little bit off the ground.
Yeah, I think that's all I can do. I mean, I don't think I can actually hide, but I mean, if I could, like, stand behind something and just kind of peek out where I'm at.
Okay. Next is going to be Oliver.
Oh, boy.
Hello.
He's going to...
Hello.
Look towards the trailer that with the door that's currently open. You, Savannah, you can still hear movement and crashes. And then finally you can hear kind of crackling. A little bit. He looks towards the door itself and goes, "Keep it burning. Come out, kitty. Come on now. There's no way out, and I will suss you out." He'll clap his hands together, almost like dig his nails into his forearms and start to spread, and you can see a little bit of black ichor starting to release. And you see his form starts to like become like tight against his bones. His skin starts to pull back. His hair actually starts to whiten, and since it's already like jet black, starts to whiten quick and slick backwards. His eyes turn almost like a full shade of red, and his fangs start to elongate. "Sister thought shortcuts was a bad idea. Who's the smart one now? Come out!" But he was not yelling to you, as you can hear bits of the wall starting to crumble near the floor. Like, where the wall and the floor meet, some pockets start to... Vera, from where you're standing, you can see one about maybe about 15 feet away from you, or about 10 to 15, excuse me. A hole, almost like a cave-in, starts to occur in one end, and you can hear... roll, as you're standing there, in front of the counter, one of the walls starts to... like almost shift a little bit, and where the wall and the floor meet, a cave-in starts to occur, and you can hear
that dead people problem.
Now we can put you guys on the map. Let's see here. So Savannah,
all I gotta say is good thing Daryl wasn't
hiding
a dick
over here,
because we'd be fucked.
Let me go and take away this thing real quick. Apologies, I'm still learning this. I'm still learning.
It's all right.
There we go.
I learned a little bit last time.
Okay. Now I'm going to put Rolly on stage. Rolly, you're currently hanging out over here. And Vera, you are standing right here.
Is the map supposed to refresh?
Is it not
Did you activate it?
Hmm?
Did you activate it?
Oh, good point. Let me activate it. Thank you so much.
I activated my map.
There's a tab that says activate. Like, he can see us, but we can't see it. I seize it now.
So there you go. And what you start to see, everyone, actually, since you're on different sides of the map, all these little holes, I can describe it to all of you guys. You start to see these black pinned, like, gaunt-looking creatures. You see that their jaw currently is slumped downwards. Like, even if it closed up, it wouldn't fully close the mouth. A singular, like, forked tongue is constantly hanging out as it starts to drool this miasma. It is almost hard to move as you start to see it, like almost like every movement causes it a little bit of pain as some of the spikes start to grind and cut along its own body. It's one of them. Each of them looks at, like, Vera, the one closest to you, like, emerges from the hole. Its stark black eyes looks at you and goes, and it's about to jump out. Same thing happens. Actually, no. Savannah, these three start to emerge, and they don't see you at the moment. You see that they, almost like in a hunter-predator like vibe. And Rolly, right behind you, as a lot of the staff hands here go, "What the fuck's going on?" See this thing starting to emerge.
Well, hello there.
Savannah, you're up.
So my brain's in two different places right now. I'm trying to figure out what makes the most sense.
Oliver would be right about here, because he did walk towards the door.
Need to remeasure something. Okay. Because I'm invisible, I am actually going to sneak up on Oliver. Wait, take that off. Off. Using Booming Blade, I'm going to strike him from the back.
Okay. You can do so with advantage.
That is going to be 24 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
I think all the dice.
Oh, that's right. A lot's going to happen here.
It's a good thing.
It's a good thing. And then, was it for the other ones? 2d8s. Sorry for the delay.
No, it's fine. I'm currently getting my stuff ready.
9. D8. So that is going to be 34 the hit. Points of damage.
34 points of damage. Yeah. You. He's currently looking around. You see him, he's actually looking in your general direction as you start to... your footsteps almost are as soft, are so soft enough where the growling from these creatures, these thorn, covered creatures, are almost like covering your own footsteps as you duck to the left and then emerge as your attack releases the invisibility spell. You have cut straight across his chest as a black ichor hits the ground. 34 points of damage. There you are.
So bonus action, I'm disengaging because I'm getting the fuck away from him. I am going to use the rest of my movement. So I was 20, so... Yeah, we're gonna run. If I climbed up these boxes, how many feet would that be?
Same amount of feet, but make me a athletics or acrobatics check.
C plus acrobatics, that's gonna be a 16.
Not a problem, you were able to...
Alright, so I'm gonna use the rest of my movement to kinda hop on the other side of these boxes.
Okay, not a problem. You can now see the two others that were here, kind of look in your, like, on your lifted vantage point, and they are currently getting ready to pounce.
Oh, great.
You can hear... Well, we'll get to that in just a second. Rolly, you're up.
I'm going to tell the lovely, lovely staff, because I'm assuming that thing that spawned behind me is by the door, right?
Yes. So the front door would be right by here, yeah.
Okay. I'm going to say... Hey guys, you value your life. Probably want to step outside that door now. I'll go ahead and hold this guy off for you. And I'm gonna go up to this guy and I'm gonna give him the business.
Okay.
For some reason, I pictured Rolly being the Kool-Aid man and bursting through the wall.
Well, I thought about doing that, yes. But then, like, I also don't want to endanger these poor kids who are just here looking for a paycheck, and all of a sudden, you know, shit goes down. And it's like, I don't get paid enough for this.
Nobody gets paid enough for
post
that.
Office.
So, yeah. Actually, what I would like to do is I would like to grapple this guy.
Okay. Roll me an athletics check.
That'll be a 26.
Yes, that definitely will allow you to grapple him. Let's see here. As you grapple him, you take 2 points of poison damage. As you wrap your arms around him, you're able to keep him steady, but as you're doing so, a lot of the serrated points and ends sink into your arms, and you can see that a little bit of the red that protrudes within the spikes start to loosen in color as they start to deplete a little bit of poison into you, and I need you to make me a con save.
Uh, 21.
You're totally fine. You're able to hold fast as you can feel a little of the burning happening within your muscles, but you're flex, hold it steady, and you're able to resist the poison.
And then I'll look back at the workers, and I'm gonna be like, "Today would be a good time to leave. I'll hold them off."
Don't worry, they have their own initiative. Perfect. So that was your action to do so. Any other things you'd like to do?
Bonus action rage. Oh, sorry. See, I'm telling you, I can't get used to this thing.
That's fine.
It's action rage.
Bonus action rage, yeah. Release that inner fire. Perfect.
I feel he's gonna hit me, so just gonna prepare.
True. After Rolly,
I don't like
is...
that you said that.
After Rolly, Savannah, you can hear more crashes happening within the trailer as I'm going to mark one piece of evidence has been burned.
Oh, we need it.
As you start to see them from your vantage point through the window, a lot of them are holding like these old school, like Middle Eastern lanterns, like where it's like almost like lamps. That are lit on one end. They're currently tossing them into a pile, like a desk with numerous papers and boxes, and the trailer is starting to catch on fire as they start to instigate more flames. So that is gone. Hold on, let me mark the right one. Here we go. Here we go. This is gone. Okay. Next up, actually, I think only one of them is going to start doing that. This one's going to start walking out. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. But he's about 5 feet underneath you. He is going to attempt to... No, he can actually do spider climb because he's a vampire. He's going to start walking up the... the boxes and get right next to you. That's his turn, but that's about it.
That's bad.
Next is going to be the crawlers.
Ew.
Let me double check their speed. The Diamaya crawlers. They have a speed of... Okay, perfect. 5, 10, 15. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. This one has to dash to get to... Savannah.
Yep. All I gotta say is if you have an area 15, effect, that'd be the time.
30. So only two of them to get to attack. 5, 10.
Oh, I don't want to be your friend. 20, cool. 25,
35, 10, 15, 25, 30. That's as far as that can go.
Yeah.
Rolly, you can hear the sound of what the hell's going on, man? this one starts to go 5, 10, 15. As the blue, light blue tiefling is being attacked.
I was gonna say, Mellow Yellow over there is probably like the most chill about this situation.
Whoa, you're ruining my buzz, bro. So let's see here. Two of them are gonna get attack on you, Savannah. So... 14 to hit.
Miss.
Just that plus 15 to hit.
Miss.
You just see like their snarled jaws starting to drop, and as they reach backwards, you can see that their palm starts to grow at a rapid pace. These numerous spikes and pincers as they try to almost, they're not trying to claw you, they're almost like they're trying to like slap you, like starting to inject you, like a palm press.
Weird.
This one is going to try to attack you, Vera. 15.
Miss.
And the one right next to you, Rolly, is going to try to do the exact same thing. That'll hit. No. That's like a 25.
No.
Okay.
They look painful to look at.
You take 3 points of poison damage, and I need you to make me a con save.
That'll be 23.
You're fine. Totally fine. After the crawlers, it's going to be the post people. Oh wait. One. Quick. Yeah.
Yeah. The blue tiefling got hit, right?
He's about to get hit. My apologies.
Okay. I use a free action after that happens?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So he's going to get hit. I'm going to tell everybody, get out now!
The blue tiefling takes 3 points of poison damage, has to make a con save, fails the con save, and is poisoned, and is actually, he slumps over and goes, ugh! You see like numerous spikes sticking out of his throat, as you can see also like his veins starting to pop out a little bit, and he starts to throw up a little bit, grabs onto the desk, and slowly tries to get out.
Ow!
He's gonna slump over the desk and fall over, prone. These guys, are you telling them to run or to save their friends, or
I'm telling them to run.
Okay. Well, the two the two goth kids absolutely will do that. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and they will leave fucking off. The dwarf, however, doesn't listen to you. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. She's gonna go for a friend. 15.
She's
gonna
fix her friend.
25. And that's about as far as they get to go. 10, 20, 15, 20. And he's going to go halfway to make sure that everyone's okay. The amethyst dragon. So that's what their turn is like. Moving back to the top of the order. Vera, you're up.
They're both within 30 feet, yeah?
They're both within 30 feet.
Can I use my action to destroy undead?
Yes, you may.
So they have to make a wisdom save.
Could you read to me what destroy undead, how is it read?
Okay, hold on, I was just there. I just moved.
That's fine, I'll make the rolls as you do that.
Starting at 8th level, an undead creature of a challenge rating 1, we know it's moved up since I level up, or lower, fails its saving throw against your turn undead feature, the creature is instantly destroyed.
Okay. What does it look like as you release your turn undead?
I think it's just a bright light, but it's like a symbol of Palor when it goes out, like from a blast.
You have a maul, right?
Yeah.
You grab your maul.
Almost. Well, not a maul, it's a mace. It's
a mace. You grab the mace, twirl it onto your hand, grabbing. You grab the shield and smack the shield with your mace as you hear as metals collides with each other and a flashbang of. I'm talking about like Indiana Jones and the Lost Ark, just as you just see. As these things are disintegrated.
Good. They're ugly.
They're ugly, and I got things to do. This ain't one of them. Okay, that was my action.
Mm-hmm.
Can I move 25 feet and then use the rest of my movement as the 10 feet of fly speed?
It does not increase your speed?
No, I know. Because my speed is 35. Oh, if I move 25 and then... I'm not good with space on this.
So essentially, let's see, because it gives you 10 feet of speed. Yeah, I'll allow that. Because I think it's worded differently, but yes, you can move 20 feet and 30 feet, or 25 feet and then 35 feet.
Why do that? Are these like these carriages are just chilling here?
Yeah, they're kind of, like, the horses are currently, like, bucking a little bit, but they have an entire carriage behind them that's locked.
Is it an action to slap one of them in the ass to kind of, like, draw attention over this way?
It would.
Damn.
I would think that would have made them run away.
The fact that they're not spooked by any of this says something about these horses.
Yeah, I was like, I don't know if they would have been spooked by when I hit my shield that hard.
Oh, you know what? Make me an animal handling check to see if everything goes the way you want it to. That's a good point. You did just create a flashbang right next to them.
My question to this, would high animal handling mean they weren't spooked or were spooked?
More along the lines of it goes the way she wants it to.
Got it.
Natural 20 again. It's a natural heavy 20. Dice, but I have a plus 4 to animal handling.
These horses reel up. You as they reel upwards and start to move forward, the carriage is locked, but the reins on them start to tighten and pull until finally they snap, and these horses run off with the leaving the carriage there.
Well, that works for me. I just need a signal in case certain guards come, and hopefully some noise. Can you do my measurement for me or my feet? I always forget how to do it.
It's the little ruler at the bottom of the thing.
Oh. Okay. So about there.
Okay, go ahead. Yeah, because you get to fly, you do not need to do an acrobatics check to go over the box.
Okay. And I kind of like fly up there, huh?
Fly up there?
Yeah, like on top of the box?
No, for right now, you are right next to the box.
Okay.
Yeah, that's as far as you can go.
Action. I'm trying to think if I have a bonus action.
Another strange thing, Vera, the moment you step into this area, you see the torchlight start to almost like rotate in a strange manner. Like, fire does not spin in place. It's one thing that does catch your eye.
I have a question. Since technically destroy undead is a cleric ability, it's not a spell, I could technically cast a spell as a bonus action.
Yes, right? You may. Do you have a bonus action spell?
Yeah. I'm debating whether I want to do it. Can I cast Holy Weapon on my... Let's see. What's got a better hit?
On my longsword.
Can you cast Holy Weapon on your longsword?
Yeah, it's a bonus action.
Yeah, I think you can. That gives you, I believe, a plus one, correct?
It gives me 2d8 of radiant damage, but other stuff happens if I hit something with it.
Okay, yeah. The light starts to...
I mean, I've seen the zombies, man. I'm assuming there's more shit in there, so...
Here's the thing about this, though.
What?
Uh-oh.
You cast the spell, and the moment you walk this close, your light hits the sword. It starts to imbue it with light, and you see this radiant crackling of energy. And finally, it starts to... Almost like a small leak within a boat, it starts to get stolen and taken into the torchlight.
That's nice. I gotta go break a torch.
In addition to that, as you... Make me a perception check real quick.
My perception went up. Yeah.
16 plus 9, whatever that is.
16 plus 9, 25. Yeah. You look down and you see that your shield is all out of charges. As you could see the same little bit of like leakage of this radiant energy that you have, and sunlight is starting to be pulled into the torch.
All right, well, I know what I'm doing next turn. Fine.
All right. Oliver's turn. Ollie is going to first... You start to see the damage you did to him, Savannah.
Mm-hmm.
His chest start to slowly stitch back together.
Grrr.
Well.
He is going to... I think he's going to smile towards you, seeing that you're kind of overwhelmed at the moment. And kind of like bring his arm up, lean his chin against his palm, watching you almost surrounded by, you can hear growling, the movements of everyone. Let's see. He looks to you and says, "Tell me, Savannah, who spoiled the fun? My sister silenced your little mockingbirds. Who spoke?
You're going to pay that."
You're so funny. I'm the smartest one here. I knew that this was an eventuality. Goodbye, Savannah.
You bastard.
He's going to walk away. Emerge into the next room, 5, 10, 15, 20, and go, "Oh, it's the holy woman. Are you liking my new gifts?" And sort of motions towards the torches. "I know what I am. I know what you are. I've been watching you. I, as much as my sister loves to brag, am the smartest one here, and you need to die." And we'll cast a spell on you. I need you to make me...
The spell of what?
You'll see.
Technically don't have anything up right now.
Make me a constitution saving throw.
Okay.
That makes me scared. Be good, Vera.
Try. Well, not bad. But I don't know what my mod is. 17?
That's a fail. Wait, 17 you said?
Yeah. I have a plus 2 to my save.
That's a fail.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Okay. This is a spell?
This is a spell.
And I shields out of fucking charges. Okay. I can't counter spell.
He was aware of your abilities.
Don't you have counter spell?
No, I can't. That's what he said. My spells literally got sucked up into the torch.
Damn it.
That's always the one who's done it. 36 points of cold damage as he releases what looks to be like this black ice and frost as it stretches outwards, and you can see almost like an icicle hand starting to crumple up, grab onto you, and you could feel the cold going through your armor. Finally, it shatters into a million pieces and drops as he hits you with a cone of cold. At that same time, you can hear as the hole is starting to accompany more sounds of screeching as a second wave is starting to come. Hope I didn't ruin totally all of your fun. No snappy comeback, no one-liners, no anger from you.
No, she doesn't give him any anger this time. I mean, if you were up close, maybe you see her eyes flicker a little bit, but it doesn't turn.
Not even a flash of red?
No.
That's going to be his turn. Savannah, you're up.
Change of course, but quick question. If I disengage, can I only disengage from one, or is it the whole crew?
Whole crew.
All right, bonus action. We're disengaging.
Perfect.
I'm gonna use my 30 feet of movement to get to this window. Can I use my tabaxi ability to jump into this window ledge?
Make me an acrobatics check.
19.
Yeah, it's a smaller window, but you're a tabaxi. Like any other cat, house cat, they can fit through things that honestly is kind of surprising. You grab onto one of the chests, or the crates here, dodge left, jump right, and you see numerous hands trying to reach out and grab onto your legs, but you scrunch forward, go into a duck and roll, and using that same momentum from your high ground, bounce, and you put your hands together, get ready for a spear through, and you crash through the window. You are now inside of the cart. The edgings of the cart are starting to... This Genesis member looks vampiric in nature, turns around, sees you in a surprise, and you see a lantern in his hand, but there's evidence currently being burnt up right now, but he doesn't have a turn yet.
So since he's surprised and I still have my action, I am going to... Boom, blaze, slash at him.
Go
like
for
he's
it.
All everything at him. That's gonna be 19 to hit.
19 hits.
So all the d6. Me sad. It's not as high as I would like it to be. Okay, so it's plus the d8. What did I just say? 27 plus 9 is
36.
There you go. 36 points of damage.
Yeah, he was not expecting you to crash through a window that was about like only about like maybe 3 feet in size. And you're a tall person. We've discussed it before. You're the smallest of the group, but on average, you guys are towering. You crash through, see over this guy, and quickly get him with a dagger. You see, you actually grab his eye, almost like it curves downwards, and he's like, ah! And you release it, and you see the eye still onto the dagger.
Ew.
Evidence.
It's kind of like...
Yeah. Ugh. It hits the floor. Is that your turn?
That's my turn.
Roll, you're up.
All right, well, again, bonus action. Get out! And this time, don't I need to make the grapple roll again?
No. That's if he tries to break your grapple, that's what happens.
Oh, he's not trying to break the grapple.
He had slashed at you. He didn't use his action to try to break.
Because he poisoned, or whatever he did to you.
So he wants to get up close to the person. Okay. Can I use my action to throw him? Since technically we're still grappling.
Fuck yeah. Let's do it.
Alright, I want to throw him opposite everybody.
So okay, this way.
Yeah.
Alright,
as hard as I can.
Roll me an athletics check. And since you're raging, you get to do that with advantage.
Alright. good, to be honest.
Don't forget to move the mic a little closer.
So I rolled a 14.
A 14?
None of those are really good.
I'm going to see if he can maybe resist it and see if he could lessen the amount of distance you roll. He got a 15 in terms of his contested athletics. You do toss him. He doesn't go prone. He doesn't take any damage. He just goes about 10 feet right about here. His claws screech and like almost claw into the ground as he skids around. His back legs are almost like animalistic as they claw into the ground as well and stop him pivoting. It's not his turn, but he's ready for something.
Okay, I'm gonna... you know what? I'm gonna get over here. I'm gonna try to block his path the best way I can.
Perfect. After that, it is going to be the Genesis members. This one has to go 5, 10, 20, 25, 30. It's gonna block the door. This one is lost an eye and he's gonna reach to his pack and pull out, let's see here. He's gonna pull out a short sword and he's gonna attempt to attack you. Let's see. Yeah. First one, 13 to hit.
Miss.
Natural 20.
That's it.
Cough, don't forget you have lucky.
For me, I don't know if that's good.
No,
for that.
You could use it on his roll.
Would you like would you like to spend a lucky point?
No, not right now.
Okay.
Yeah, no, he does it to Nick all the time. That's how I know.
You take 9 points of slashing damage.
Ow.
And then he's going to attempt to bite you.
Boo.
16 to hit.
Miss.
You see him. And I think it's because he's missing the eye that he quickly brings out a sword. The first swipe, you dodge out of the way, but you almost actually touch the wall of fire that's right next to the trailer. You instinctively have to lurch back as he gets you right into the stomach and releases it, and immediately sees the blood. The bloodlust hits his eyes and he tries to grapple you and reach for you. You're too slippery and you slip out. And because none of them spent a turn throwing evidence into a fire, the next evidence does not catch. Next is going to be the crawlers. Let's see here. Where are you? This one emerges. This one emerges. But that's their turn. This one. 5, 10. These guys are not smart. So they're currently trying, all three of them are trying to get into the hole that Savannah just ducked into. As Savannah, you can see numerous hands going right next to you. One is right outside the window. It's going to try to attack with you with disadvantage. Oh, that's pretty good. Uh, 21 to hit. You take 3 points of poison damage, and I need you to make me a con save.
Ah, fuck. I hate con saves. That's going to be a 17.
17. You save. Oh my God. Yeah. Rolly, this one right next to you, is going to attempt to slash at you. Mm-hmm. 10 to hit.
Mm-mm-mm.
This one over here is going to jump the wall, get back to the blue tiefling, who's now prone on the ground, attack with advantage. Hits. How much points did he take last time? He took 3. He takes an additional 2 points of damage. He's looking really bad now.
I hope that buzz was worth it.
He throws up again, and the dwarven woman is almost looking freaked out, like she's seeing her friend getting mauled, as you just see the creature almost bite into the leg of the tiefling and starting to scratch at the stomach. The blue tiefling is starting to turn a bit purple, bit sickly in color. You could just no longer speaking in actual words, just feeling nothing but a bunch of poison rushing through his veins, or their veins, excuse me. That's the crawlers. What is she gonna do? Well, let's do the easy one. The amethyst dragon fucks off.
Finally!
She's not that type of woman. What'd she do? She grabs the equivalent of like a stapler next to her and just throws it at this guy. And essentially he's going to try to drag her friend. 10, 15.
A stapler's something.
I don't think they got too much in the postal service.
Especially one of those heavy duty staplers. Those things hurt.
And Rolly, if you're yelling like you need to run, she's going to go, I'm not leaving my friend.
I think there's going to be much left of your friend.
I'm not there.
I'm just saying.
I'm just saying. Maybe you should have ran when I said so.
It's really cold hearted.
Well, I mean, I
can't. Cold-blooded.
Back to the top of the order. Actually, before the end, Oliver is going to use... Oh, no, he doesn't. Okay. Never mind. Vera, you're up.
You'll fuck off. She's going to take out her sword.
Mm-hmm.
See how far this is. Oh, that's only 10 feet. Okay. And get to this torch over here and try and hit it.
Roll me attack. I'll tell you this. Just don't roll one.
A 12.
A 12? Well, it had an AC of 5.
Okay.
Okay.
Roll damage.
I just want to make sure I do something that's actually not magic to test it out before wasting another fucking spell. Not bad. 11 points.
It only had 10 HP as you cut the torch. It slides off the brazier that's currently holding it, and it dissipates.
Okay. I didn't get anything back, huh?
No.
Okay, that was 10 feet. Let me see how far I can go with this one. Okay. And that's like the rest of my movement. Right there.
Okay.
I can't hit it. I was gonna say I could bonus action to get on the other side of that other one and hit it, but I can't hit it. How does Lila work? Like, I have to do a spell, huh?
Yeah, it's a...
She doesn't just bamf out, right?
No, it's essentially using your Find Familiar spell.
Okay. That'll end my turn.
Okay. It's gonna be Oliver's turn. You start to see the remaining wounds that Savannah caused currently, like, the clothing he's worn is slashed open. You see a bit of his chest as it fully heals.
I think she's just muttering underneath her breath like, hurry the fuck up, Daryl.
I will remind you guys that the post office is in the middle of the city and Daryl is posted on the very top. So it's going to take a few rounds for him to get here.
No, I know. But she can still say, hurry the fuck up, Daryl.
Yeah, I think that'll be fun. Okay, he's already casted that. He's casted that. So that's gone. Yeah, he'll walk over to you, Vera.
Of course he will.
And he is going to attempt to... You see him pull... Actually, no, he doesn't have any weapons. He actually extends a bit of his claws on his fingers. And that is going to be a 21 to hit.
Barely hits. Lucky you.
I need another D8. Where are you? Oh, there it is.
Luckily, Vera's a tank.
I don't like that he took my magic away, because it would kill his, kill his ass because of what he is.
He didn't take your magic away. He just took away any radiance.
Yeah.
That's going to be 11 points of slashing damage as he sinks into the spaces between your armor. You start to feel like his claws are starting to scratch and pull away at the flesh. The bloodlust takes him and he grapples you, or he attempts to grapple you and bite you. Uh-huh. So now he's going to try that. That's going to be a 19.
Miss. I think she just shoves the shield in his face.
He tries. He actually jumps, tries to get you, and you pull the shield. And he's currently like trying to gnaw on the shield until you push him away.
I'm going to bless this shield next time so that way it dents your fucking teeth.
Oh, come on. It's not going to be that simple. I'm somewhat disappointed, really. And he's an end of turn. Savannah, you're up.
Trying to decide how I want to play this. Yep, we're going to do that. So, action, I'm going to cast Lucky Oasis. So the Smith still.
You hold on to that, the luck, these almost duplicative energy as the mirrored versions appear right next to you.
And I'll use my bonus action just to kind of flick my dagger at this one right here, so he'll get some damage.
Go for it.
Be nice. 17.
17 does it.
Yay. So, it's only the one. That's going to be 5. That's going to be 8 points of damage.
8 points of damage. It is looking pretty bad.
Still standing, goddammit.
Still standing.
I'll end my turn. I'm not leaving the trailer.
Got it. Roll, you're up. You're muted.
You're literally low now.
No, not get used to this thing. Yes, Rolly's about had enough with this guy. So he's gonna move to attack.
Go for it.
Okay. 27 hit.
27 does hit.
10 damage. I recall that the I believe I had what was the last encounter we had?
I think it's still set to Radiant.
I think so. Yeah. I think that's what it was. Alright. Thirteen points of damage.
You cut into it, and it's barely standing. You see that, like, you slice through its shoulder, and its arm, almost like it's a rotting corpse, snaps off and drops to the floor as it starts to, like, move on its own until finally the last bits of nerve endings and signals stop.
I needed a roll of strength save.
Oh yeah. 5.
Oh. This time, rather than moving, actually, rather than taking its space, I'm not going to take its space, and I'm going to instead focus the rest of my movement, so I'd be fine. Perfect. I'd come over here, and I'd tell them, go now!
She's gonna look to you and goes, that's what I'm trying to fucking do!
Now! I will... I'll end my turn then.
Okay, perfect. It is now gonna be the crawler's turn. This one, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. They're gonna get right about here, but they can't attack. This one's gonna get up to you, Rolly. Uh, 12 to hit. Nope. Kind of figured. Since Amber just went away, what's fine. This one is going to be a little smart and kind of go around here, but can't get through. This one's going to take its place. And they're both going to attempt to attack you, Savannah, with disadvantage.
Do they get double disadvantage because of the mirror image?
That's if they even... Oh, that's right. They have to roll something before they try to hit you, right?
Well, no. If they roll with disadvantage, try to hit me, and if they do hit, there's something else.
Right. I know there is no double disadvantage, but they rolled a 2, so that's not going to work. The next one is going to roll... That's going to be a... They both rolled a 16, so that's going to be a 22 to hit.
That's now, going to hit, though. I need you to roll another d20.
A 2.
See, you miss. You hit one of the duplicates.
You see the arms. You're totally focused on this guy, and immediately just one of the duplicates fades away. Now that you're here, Vera, this one is going to lurch forward. That's going to be a 14 to hit.
Miss.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. It's going to dash. Cannot attack this round, but it gets right to you. The post office workers, they're going to go 5, 10, 15, 20. They're going to get an attack of opportunity from the dwarf. Gets hit.
With her stapler.
She takes 4 points of damage. What makes the con save, she is not poisoned, as the creature scratches at her. She goes, fuck you! And moves the remainder 5 feet and is on its way out. The tiefling individual is just, like, trying to keep whatever is inside his stomach, or their stomach, in.
Like, I could probably fix it, but not right now.
Vera, you're up.
All right. I have a question. Is that green thing, like that divider, an actual divider?
This green thing?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's a wall.
Ah, fuck. And no time like the present.
I gotta see how this works, because I've never used it before. And no, it's not radiance. My app broke.
She's doing something.
Well, I'm reading how this is gonna go. I think I can create blade barrier on top of them, right? Like on a straight line.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think she's just gonna turn and kind of like smile at Ollie, because she's like, I'm not like, Vera doesn't think this is gonna worth all her energy, at least to deal with him. Like, she just needs to get her friends out. But like, she's just gonna smile. And then you see her eyes turn red, and she casts Blade Barrier on them. So
how much of a length is it?
It says the wall appears within range, which is within 90 feet of me. You can make a straight wall up to 100 feet long, 20 feet high, and 5 feet thick.
Okay, I think you have the ability to draw. Uh-huh. And if not... Use your mouse and show me where you'd like the wall.
How do you draw?
On the left-hand side, there should be a little pencil icon. Let me know if you see it.
I do not see a little pencil icon.
I'm sorry?
I said I do not see a little pencil
icon. So then use your mouse and show me where... Because you can see my mouse movement.
Yeah.
Where would you like the wall?
Like, going this way.
Okay, so let's start. Where do you want it to start? Here?
Because it can go 100 feet.
Oops, that is way too big.
So let it go its whole 100 feet, like, through Ollie and through this guy in front of me.
Let's see here. We'll make it 10. Blade wall. We'll make this a bit red, because you're red right now. So you want it to go, like, why is it... Oh, I have to... We're learning, folks. We're learning.
We're learning the spell, and we're learning how to draw.
There we go. So, like, this...
Yeah, like straight through.
Oops.
Yeah.
Well, God, I wish I... How do I get rid of that here?
I mean, the line's fine for me, but I just keep in mind that it's like 5 foot thick.
Like that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this lasts
I'm
for...
I'm gonna get better.
up to 10 minutes as long as I keep concentration. Says when the creature enters the wall's area for the first time on a turn or starts its turn there, the creature must make a dex saving throw.
What kind of damage does it do?
Slashing.
You got through it. Yeah.
That's why I said it's not radiant.
It's not radiant. Still use divine magic, and you reach for your blade. The blade itself starts to emanate numerous illusionary copies as it until enough of it is just almost like a whole like Saw game where it's just moving in a straight line of these numerous duplicate illusionary copies of your blade start to spin and rotate within this space.
Okay. So do they make their dex save now?
On their turn.
Okay.
So what it says on the start of their turn. Or if they enter it. So that's your action.
It says the space is also difficult terrain. But I don't know how this works for cover, because it says the wall provides 3/4 cover to creatures behind it.
Yeah. No one's behind it. They're in it.
Okay. Am I behind it, though?
How do you define behind it?
I don't know. I'm not in it.
You're on one side of the wall.
That's what I was like. I don't want to deal with that. Okay.
Fighting urge.
That's my...
Build the wall joke. Sorry.
That's my action. Bonus action, I guess, face step to get the fuck out of the way.
Okay, which way are you going?
30 feet. Let's see.
That's a wall. You have to see where you're going.
I think I'd have to do it this way.
Once again, that's a wall. You have to see it. So this here is a wall.
I hate that thing. I think I can't go the full 30 feet then, right?
You don't have
to. I just have to go...
Okay. It's within 30 feet. I'll say that much.
Yeah. Okay. So she'll face step this way. Her hair is still purple because I was adamant about not changing it. So
what does your purple reaction do?
I think we said that was spring because she didn't have a color for that. So let's see. Says I can choose to touch somebody else and they can do it in.
Okay, you're obviously not going to do that.
Yeah.
So, dissipate, return right next to this door that's currently open, and you look into the door. It's a closet.
That ends my turn, though.
All right. It's going to be Oliver's turn. He starts his turn within the blade wall. What does he need to make?
He needs to make a dex save.
Dex save. Let's see what kind of... Okay. That is going to be a 16.
He fails.
Okay.
Give me a second, I need more dice.
So he's gonna take 6d10 slashing.
6d10, got it.
Big numbers.
Hoping.
Sorry about that.
Okay. 18, 25, 28, 35 points of slashing.
35 points of slashing damage. He just stands there, and his feet, legs, and hips starts going as numerous cuts and slashes start to cut through his body. He takes a step. Well, actually, he can't because this guy's blocking. So it's 10, 20, because they're difficult terrain, 25. He walks out of it, Vera, and he is... You just see numerous drips of blood. Like, he's leaving a trail behind.
I was like, yeah, I'm sure he's pissed. So am I.
Make me a wisdom save.
Okay. Is it for sleep or charm at all?
It is a charm.
I get advantage.
Yes, you do.
3 Yeah, I will take the advantage. What's my save? 25. 16 plus 9.
He holds a hand out to you, and then it sort of starts to loosen. A smile curls around his face, and he goes, "Enough running." why don't you come back? And you hear his voice, come back, come back, come back. Almost echo within your mind like a cave. But your mind, you close your eyes and you shut that voice out. Almost like a parasite that you have to push out of your mind until finally you return back and you have resisted his charm effect. That was his action. Savannah, you're up.
Okay. Where's the fire in the trailer?
It's currently in this corner right next to you.
Oh, actually, that works out. Bonus action. Dagger, stab vampire dude again.
Go for it.
C plus four. That is going to be 16 to hit.
16 hits. Just hits.
That's going to be 8 points of damage.
You... It's like you're keeping him up because you're taller than him, so you're definitely, your arm is pulling him upwards. His arms tried to reach out to you, but due to the length, he can't quite get to your neck until finally you start to see the yellow in his eyes start to dull. The fight within the body starts to almost loosen until finally the arm drops.
All right, I'm going to use my action for something weird. Can I use my water stone to put out the fire?
Oh, the cleansing stone.
Yeah, the cleansing stone.
That's not the way the spell or the magic works, but...
I stomp out the fire?
I was going to say, roll me an arcana check to see if maybe you can manipulate the stone in a way that that'll work.
Let's see. What is my... That is going to be... Where is it? 17.
17. It's breaking the way the stone works. So what's going to happen here is that you spend a moment trying to get it to do that. You keep on like focusing at the stone to release a gout of water, and you're just cleansing yourself constantly.
But I did walk to it, so would the water go to it?
Well, that's the thing, is that you're starting to feel the fire underneath your elbow and arm as you're, like, standing over the fire trying to get it to go. What happens is that it does burn the next piece of evidence until finally you concentrate on the magic of the rock as a fire hits your arm, and... That moment, as you are connected with the fire is emitted removed, and you take 8 points of fire damage.
Worth it.
But the fire is gone.
It's the cleanest Savannah's ever been when she comes out. It's like three baths.
Any movement?
Nah, I'll wait for them to come inside.
Okay. Rolly, you're up.
Okay. I have had about enough. I'm going to attack the guy in front of me.
Go for it.
That is going to be a 21 to hit.
21 does hit.
Uh, 19 points of damage to the guy in front of me.
Okay. You take 4 points of poison damage from doing physical damage to him. But at the same time, you reach back with your great axe and you cut this guy in a diagonal bisection from the neck all the way down to the hip. As it... You feel a little bit of the needles and spikes jab into your arm on the full swing, but it... drops downwards, and
all right, and then in the fell swoop, almost like I planned that all along, I'm gonna then charge with the axe engaged to this guy, and I'm gonna hit him for the second attack.
Go for it.
Uh, 22 to hit.
That hits.
It's gonna be, yeah, it's gonna be a lot. It's gonna be 20 plus points of damage.
20. This one as well. Actually, what you do is that you kneel down slightly using that spinning momentum. You cut where the knees are, as you cut both knees, it drops down, and using that same momentum, bring up the axe and slashes downwards, bisecting him in a almost like a lateral way. As it you still have movement. That was like, thinking you just moved 10 feet, so if you'd like to move cool. more, you can.
Yes, I'll shout back to them. Now! And then I'm going to use the remainder of my movement to get over here. Are there any obstacles in the way?
So this right here is a wall. So there's a door right here.
Okay. So I'm going to go 10, 20, 30. I have just enough to get to the door.
We'll say
the door's there, or
we'll say the door's right there. You open the door, okay. And you see more of these creatures starting to like yell. This one's like in the middle of
just blades swinging,
a wall of blades, and you see barely a figure over this because one person's blocking your way along with a crate. But you do see Vera on the opposite side.
Destroy the torches.
This one's destroyed.
I destroyed one. I need to destroy the other one.
Torches, you say?
There's one right by your head.
He's preventing holy magic. That one's destroyed. I hit that one.
I can see no torches.
Okay, and you have to walk into the room. It's fine.
Okay.
But this makes sense, Rolly, because it's now the crawlers. Oh, no, not yet. It's going to be the Genesis member. This one is going to rush to you, Savannah, because you ruined their plans. And is going to attack twice with a short sword.
I was going to say, Spiky dude owes me a save.
This is the Genesis member.
No, I know.
Natural 1.
Ooh.
And a 14.
Both miss.
And now it's going to try to grab you.
No.
16?
No. Miss. Yay.
Oh my god. Now we do the crawlers.
Okay.
Before we do yours, Vera, one thing to mention. This is good that Rolly can stand here. Rolly, you can hear screaming as the second wave starts to emerge from the hole back here.
Oh, God.
It emerges. This one as well. But that's as much as they can do.
If they don't get out, so help me God.
Now, this one needs to make a dex save, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fail. Not too bad. 10, 18. 23 points of slashing.
23 points of slashing. This guy's gone. Just a full blender.
Hey, technically I need one of my dice. That's only 5. Now I only rolled a 1. 24.
Did you miss that die for Ollie?
I think I did.
Roll another.
Because I was like, wait, that's 5, not 6. Okay. He gets an extra 2 points, so he would have had 37 on him.
Got it. This one is going to look at Rolly.
That D10. 5, 10,
15, 20, 25, and attack. 17?
Yep.
Finally! hey!
Wait!
That sounds low for you, Rolly.
Wait!
Yes.
Joke's on you!
Oh, it's 18 now!
I'm like, I'm 17, so...
Oh, yeah, he tries to reach out. You see you just bring up your foot to stop him midway and you push him back.
Yeah, we'll say he's the closest one thus far.
Yeah. These two are still going to try to attack you, Savannah, with disadvantage. 20.
With the disadvantage?
Yeah, I gotta roll another 1 for your lucky. 7. I think
you hit. You hit the duplicate.
Pops. This one's gonna walk in and attempt to attack you. This one does not have disadvantage, so that's gonna be a 23 to hit.
That hits.
Do you have any more duplicates?
Nope.
Oh, I should roll with disadvantage because you don't have any more. That's it.
No.
You take 4 points of poison damage, and I need you to make me a con save.
Okay, so 4, con, a natural 20.
You're fine. Oh, God. Just need you guys to fail.
No.
No, don't put that on me.
No.
That's going to be the crawler's turns. The post workers, they are definitely getting the last of their movement, getting the F out of here. Vera, you're up.
She's just like pissed at this moment. And I don't know if I should do something. It's an action to do divine intervention, right?
It is an action to do divine intervention. Roll me a D100.
Yes, sir.
You have to roll a 14 or lower.
Holy. Hold on, there's a certain one because it was rolling weird the other day and I was like, I'm gonna use that one. Yeah, finally.
She mutters offside off the mic.
Hold on. I'm getting it.
That tattoo on Vera's back starts to glow bright. Now, before you roll, I need you to tell me what type of intervention are you looking for here?
Essentially, she's going to ask for... I don't want to make it sound so corny, but it is. Like, power of the sun, i.e. radiance, to hit Ollie with, like, all of its might.
Okay.
Dead center.
Okay, got it. Yeah.
Because she knows she can't do it the way it's happening, so she's thinking if she does this and he does it, maybe it'll work.
I don't like this.
We'll see.
Move the phone out of the way. Come on, he does. No.
No?
Too high.
You speak the words, it actually works, but the torch right next to you steals it away.
That's what I was wondering was going to happen.
Okay, that's fine. I'd at least try.
Oliver smiles and goes, do you think I didn't think of that either? Come on now, you brought a man back to life.
She won't say anything. That's not the only thing she brought back to life. I'm trying to see for a bonus action that isn't radiant.
He's actually going to turn around, seeing Rolly burst open the door and go, Mr. Barnwell! Glad for you to join us.
I have a question. Is spiritual weapon, like, it just does slashing, I think. So would this technically...
What does it say?
I have to get all technical now. Hold on. D8 plus my spellcasting modifier. So it's not like radiant...
Yeah, it's force damage.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to bonus action spiritual weapon over his head.
Did we ever... I don't think we ever put in your spiritual weapon.
Oh, in Foundry? I don't think we did.
But let me see if I can find...
That picture. You had a picture for it.
I did, but I don't have time to upload it. So
just
what I'm going to try to do...
upload a dot.
Didn't we use, like, something else as a supplement the last time?
I haven't used it recently. I think we were using that for the Guardian dude.
Let's see. Monsters, background, class features. We're going to put... Can this work? No. No, that's not it. Monsters, background, features, class features, feats, items? Let me see if I can just put sword. Nope.
You know, retroactively, I'm going to say I don't put it over Ollie's head and I put it over the torch. See if I can destroy it. Since we haven't put it there yet.
Okay, we're going to put this flying sword for now.
That's fine.
So where would you like to put this?
Over the torch so I can try and...
Oh, you're going to attack the torch?
Yeah.
All right, make me an attack with it.
I think I rolled another 12 again. Oh, no.
Technically, 13.
It's got an AC 5. Go ahead and roll me damage.
D8 plus my modifier.
9 points of damage.
The torch is barely hanging on.
Okay. I know it has 10 points. Can I free action yell something to Rolly?
Yeah.
It's going to piss him off, but in the right way. I'm going to yell to Rolly basically that his sister is responsible for the hit on your family. Since he already outed it.
We will see what happens at the start of the next round.
And that ends my turn.
Okay.
Like, since he likes having a big mouth and telling us all his plan.
Okay. After Vera, it's going to be Ollie's turn. He's going to hear you yell that and go, "Funny, Mr. Bonwell, I haven't actually met you face to face. You know, it's kind of poetic that your friend's guild is going to kill your family. Did you know that?"
And we will see what happens at the start of the next round.
He's in a grumble, kind of. He likes to talk, that's the problem. And his wounds start to heal. Start of this round. He's going to smile and go, "If your will is too high, how about your friends?"
I don't know.
Reach back and Rolly, you need to make me a wisdom save.
Come on, Rolly.
Well, that wouldn't be hopeful. A flat 16.
Flat 16. You hear his voice of, "How about you? How about you? How about you?" And then finally, your eyes open. And you hear his voice, almost like a secondary being within your mind goes, "Take out your friends. Use that barbarian rage."
Mm-mm.
And your eyes shift a bit green. You're under his charm effect, meaning that he's got a almost like a dominate person on you. He'll smile to you, Vera, and go, "Well, I think..." He sort of looks at your spiritual weapon, looks around, seeing as all is happening. "I think I'll bid you adieu." 10.
I can't counterspell it because of the damn thing.
He's going to make a dex save, fail it, go ahead and roll me a damage.
Oh, good.
10, 15, 20, 25, 30. He's already used his action, so that's where he's going to stay.
Points of damage.
It's almost like his wounds are heal and
it's also difficult terrain if he tries to get
there. I counted 10.
Okay.
Yeah. But he is walking away. Oh, and he actually turns around to Yuvier and goes, "By the way, dear, I would burn those holes quickly because they're not going to stop." On his next turn, we'll see what happens. Savannah, you're up.
Vampire dude, wisdom saving throw, please.
Ooh.
The charm person that's on Rolly, because he took damage right now, he doesn't have to try concentration, right?
No, it's not like that.
Get it. I try.
This person rolled a 10.
So, suggestion. Fire's out. Go find your master and tell him.
Okay. You start to, as you speak the words, the creature is like in a readied stance and its body starts to relax.
Bonus action. He's in my melee range, right?
Yes.
Bonus action, swipe at that one.
Go for it.
That's going to be 15.
15 hits.
And that is going to be a 7.
7. You cut through him quickly, and you take 1 point of poison damage.
Ouch.
As you... you actually start to cut a little bit of the thorns and needles that are sticking out of him, but he still stands.
Okay, I'll figure out how to deal with that. I'll end my turn there.
Okay. Rolly, you're up. You've gotten a command from your master.
So I need to... I heard 2 commands, so I need to, I need to know what commands were issued, or what command was issued, please.
You were asked to dispatch your, friends with your barbarian rage.
Okay. I'm going to follow that command as best as I possibly can. And I'm going to, let's see. I'm going to activate a rage.
Okay.
Then go in the door. Okay. How big is the door?
It's about 5 feet. So essentially, this guy is kind of blocking your path. If you wanted to, you could push him out of the way.
Can I attack him?
Yeah, you could attack him. He didn't say...
Because he's technically in my way.
He's technically in your way. He's holding you back from the command your master gave you.
Okay, so I will seeing this guy as an impediment to my task, I'm going to attack him.
Go for it.
Now he's Kool-Aid Man.
Okay, that is going to be 26 to hit.
That hits.
Damn it, hold on, re-roll that one. There we go.
I'm also going to say he rolled a 12 for his save.
14 points of damage.
He's still up. So, if you like, you can push him and move.
I will push him and move. So I think the only thing I could do here, given that, would be to... no longer attack him since he's no longer blocking my path.
You can go around him.
And then move around. So I'm going to go... That was... does that count as movement, by
the way? That doesn't, actually.
Oh, all right. So it'll be 5, 10...
But that's a wall,
15.
By the way. This here is a wall.
You have to go straight.
Sorry. I don't see the walls.
So you'd essentially have to be like this. 5, 10.
Okay. Move me over here. Actually, I can't even...
You have to go straight towards
5,
him.
10, 15... 20. Because we're over here. The only way to get to here is through this door here.
Oh.
This is
a
wall.
Yeah, I can't see the wall, so I have no idea. Okay. So then guide me to the wall.
So 5, 10. What's your speed?
40.
So you moved here. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
He's going to get right to me.
He's going right at Vera.
You have 35 speed of movement, or what was it?
40.
40?
I have 40.
You can get right to Vera. So, Vera, this is what you see. You hear Oliver look over to Rolly, give a command. Rolly sort of becomes a bit statured and straight, immediately swings at this one creature. It falls back. He rushes forward and immediately, like almost like a football player, skirts around him and starts rushing towards you like a train. He actually smashes through this box as you... like a juggernaut, just...
Does he smash through the torch?
No.
Damn.
Had at least you're standing right next to Rolly.
So question. I know I'm supposed to activate the command, but I can still... I'm still, like, conscious and, you know, I can do whatever I want as long as it follows this command, right?
You were asked to dispatch your friends. So
yeah,
I
still retain my personality and whatnot, right?
We'll say.
Okay, so I'm going to say that, and I'm going to go up to Veer and I'm going to say, I'm so sorry, in like the meanest face possible. And I'm going to do my second attack.
Go for it.
Because I was asked to dispatch my enemies, or my friends, I'm so sorry. I will reckless attack this.
Go for it. Thank you for playing the part.
Roleplay, baby!
Yeah!
That will be a 25 to hit.
Hits.
Roll your damage.
Are you resistant to radiant?
Not resistant. No. I can give radiant, but I'm not resistant to radiant.
Because the torch is still here, Rolly, do not roll your house's call.
Where is this torch?
The torch is above your head.
It takes
is
in
it
the
that
radiant.
Little sword thing I see?
It's where the sword is over it right now, but yes.
Okay. That will give me another question. Let me do this first.
Okay.
I was like, radiant.
That'll be.
Get sucked up.
18 points of damage.
18 points of slashing damage. And Vera, roll me a con save.
Yeah. I already did that. I can't do that again.
No. Not a strength save. Con save.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, no.
What have I done? Oh, no.
What dice do I roll for this? Okay. 16?
The wall of swords still stay.
I wouldn't be that.
Isn't he on the wrong side of the wall now?
Okay. So, because question for the DM, because that basically hindered an attack, can I consider that a hindrance to my goal?
Yes, you could definitely use your bonus action to do a wide swing and hit the one behind you.
Okay, I'd like to use my bonus action to do just that.
Roll me an attack.
This is the one that's holding on by a thread anyways, right?
Actually, it's got one hit point, I think. No.
What do you mean, no?
Role playing.
But you saw it suck your energy away. It's messing up your order.
Yeah, I know. Action surge.
Okay, yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to turn around from Vera, and I'm going to attack this thing.
Okay, first attack. You get to roll with advantage because you're still doing reckless.
Okay, that's a nat 20. I don't need to roll again.
Okay, this torch is gone.
That's yeet, baby.
On a torch.
It's almost like, yeah, on a torch. And what happens, Vera, is that he strikes you the first time, sees a little bit of the energy being pulled to the torch, and just not even looking at it, just springs down the arm. The torch falls. It dissipates. You still have a second action, or a second attack.
Yeah.
I don't get anything back when that goes, right?
And I said, I hope that helps. And I'm going to attack Vera.
You get to attack with advantage again. These torches take away powers, they do not give it back.
Oh, Vera. Oh no, it's another nat 20.
Good.
Not only do you get to roll the damage, but also House's Call.
And Brutal Critical.
And Brutal Critical.
Oh, I'm so sorry!
Of all the time, Trolley.
Oh.
I don't think you'll kill her unless you roll hell
high. I will, but I'm so sorry.
Knock on wood, they're poor rolls.
That was meant for them. I'm so sorry.
We don't need Vegas energy like right now, Steve.
Oh.
God damn you, DM God.
There's a lot of things happening right now.
Oh yeah, and it's two.
Oh, two dice, because you you hit that level.
Yeah.
Two brutal critical dies. So I think that's
I can't
4d12
reaction and like forcibly make him take damage, right?
It has to be a willing creature.
And they don't make a save.
No,
but I can be willing, right?
He's just
technically my command is just to dispatch them.
Yeah,
not to not do what they say.
I'm gonna say.
Just curious, because we haven't tried it this way. We've always talked about, like, what if one day Vera, like, forcibly makes somebody take a hit, like, for her that way, but I don't know, like, what the game mechanics
are. I guess here's the question. Here's the question.
Was it suggestion, or was it charm person?
No, because the channel divinity is, like, shared burden, but normally Rolly willingly takes it, but I can, like, technically... Me and Mike talked about, like, what if I force somebody to take that damage?
No, it has to be a willing creature.
Oh.
It always has to be a willing creature, but Rolly brings up a good point, is that while his actions are being carried out by a force, his will is still there, so we're going to handle it this way. Vera, you're going to roll me a persuasion check. And because it's through Oliver's charm... he's going to roll a persuasion check against yours.
Oh, that should be fun. He seems like a charisma.
Can
boy.
She give herself guidance?
No, that is
no,
action.
That's an action.
Yeah. While that happens, I will roll damage.
Go for it.
That's not how guidance works. Okay, not bad, but I don't know what my persuasion is. Dirty 20.
25.
Yeah.
Eh.
Unfortunately.
That was like as high as I was going to get unless it was a natural 20.
Well, he's not making the I'm sorry face, so maybe?
Well, yeah, I haven't crunched the numbers yet.
She didn't really take hits until Ollie, because things weren't getting her.
But going back to his this bastard ass study us, so. Oh, there's the sorry face.
And then, what's my...
I don't know if that was a sorry face or I ate something bad.
44 points of damage.
44 points of damage.
Okay, she's still up.
Make me a con save, Vera.
Oh, for the wall.
Damn, Vera.
For the said wall. I don't think it's up. That is 13.
The wall fades.
That's okay.
Like I said, he was on the wrong side of it anyways.
That is your turn, Rolly. That was a solid turn.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
This guy scoots beyond 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. 35 bumps into Rolly because there's a wall, and kind of like is confused. And he looks to you, Rolly, and goes, I need to tell the master.
Is that bump, could that bump be considered an attack?
No, it's not really an attack. But what do you say as he says that?
Okay, so Rolly got issued a command, and he's trying to execute it as faithfully as possible. And something bumped into me. So Rolly's first instinct is it's something trying to hit him.
Okay.
It could be like a party member. I actually haven't.
You haven't. It's almost like a body hitting an illusionary body. It's just poof, you can't see through it right now.
Yeah.
He's not gonna be. Let's see. He's gonna try to squeeze past you. He's not gonna be able to. So he just sort of like tries to get past, and then finally gets upset and it decides to attack you.
So fucked up now.
That's gonna be a 9. You just see a claw come out, and you just sort of move out of the way, and you're like, this person's trying to kill me.
For all intents and purposes now, this is trying to stop me from achieving my goal.
Correct.
It dies first.
I would argue that your goal is right in front of you. Whatever's hindering you, probably is second nature to what the goal is right in front of you. Veer is your first.
Well, can I at least strike him first?
Sure. You'd at least have to make one strike on Vera on your turn. Okay. After that is the crawler's turn. This one's gonna go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. This one's finally gonna move out of the way. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Get right about there. This one's gonna try to attack you, Savannah, with disadvantage. Mm-hmm. That's a natural 1. Perfect. All that is happening with the crawlers. This one's going to try to attack you, Vera.
Oh, good.
That's not going to hit with a 7. And then this one's going to try to hit you, Savannah. That's going to be a 16.
Miss.
God, you guys are got such a bigger AC now. Postal workers are gone. Vera, you're up.
Thank God, because I was like, man, this guy's gonna die. I wish I could do the healing first, but I can't, because I got a problem in front of me. Can I dispel the effect on Rolly at a 4th level?
Yes, you may.
Okay.
See what happens? The torches are gone.
Oh, that would have worked. That's not radiant.
The dispel, and Rolly, the charm, this little secondary voice in your head, dissipates.
I'm so sorry.
And she looks pissed at you.
I'm so sorry.
Like, aggravated because now she's got two of these idiots on the side of her. Okay, that was my action.
You have a bonus action with your spiritual weapon still.
Yeah, I know, but I was trying to heal and I can't.
Are you? Yeah. Well, no, you did a leveled spell.
Yeah. And he can't go through the... I don't think the sword can go through the wall.
No.
So I'll let it try and hit that spiky guy.
Okay, roll me an attack.
16 plus 9, I'm sure hits.
That hits. Roll me damage.
D8. Oh, 8 plus 4, so 12 points of damage.
12 points of damage. It's still up, but you cut through one of its arms as it sort of growls at you.
Okay. Ends my turn. I'm not going to move.
Oliver.
That dick.
Going to heal.
Oh, damn it, Daryl. Hurry it up. And stupid Killian. Weenie.
What'll be a fun thing to do here? Okay, let me try that then. Vera, roll me an intelligence save.
Oh, that's gonna be good. I'm not dumb, but I'm not like super smart. Oh no, I'm gonna roll a big guy. He's better. He is better. 19 plus 1.
Yeah, you succeed.
I was like, I don't trust this other one.
You look at Rolly and then at this crawler, and for a flash, Rolly looks like a giant behemoth version of this crawler, and you are having a hard time distinguishing which one is a foe, and then he flashes back.
I think she just shakes her head like and rubs her eyes a little bit.
Yeah, Oliver goes, well, have fun, you three. Don't burn the place down now. And he's going to go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and dimension doors out.
I was going to say, I hope the horse runs him over.
The horse isn't there, remember?
Oh, it doesn't give back my spell. I was going to say, damn.
No, it doesn't give back. I've been telling you, it doesn't do that. That's his turn. Savannah, you're up.
Bonus action, distract this one, and then I'm going to swipe at him.
Okay, yeah, you quickly reach out your hand, a purplish mage armor starts to distract this one, and you have advantage.
That's going to be 17 to hit.
That hits.
Let's see. So not that...
By the way, guys, the blue tiefling only had 2 HP left.
He did.
He did?
No, he's not dead.
Oh.
He was just poisoned.
He's about to be.
Let's see.
Hey, man, Vera didn't know about no stupid tiefling. She just trying to deal with this mess.
That is going to be 21 points of damage. 21 points of damage.
You cut this guy into ribbons.
I'll move to use... No, I already used my bonus action. I'll end my turn.
Okay. Roll, you're up.
Okay. Oliver's completely gone, right?
Yeah, you actually saw him stand. Something dropped. He's almost like pulls a hand out and a gateway starts to form and he steps through it.
Okay. Direct his attack on the guy in front of him.
Steve, Mike.
Not even mute. Damn.
There you go. I don't know. It's weird.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know what to do anymore.
I'm going
to
get you a mic.
Well, anyway. Rolly's mad. He's going to direct his attention to the guy in front of him.
Got it.
Move to attack.
Left or right?
Spike
that's going to be...
I'm assuming the one that attacked him.
This guy.
Okay. Got it.
Well, never mind.
That is going to be a dirty 20 to hit.
That hits.
Okay.
22 points of damage.
You take 3 points of poison damage, and this guy is cut to ribbons. Just...
Okay. Then it's going to dawn on Rolly that something tried to swing at him from behind, so I can't see the thing, right?
No, but you know he's there.
Okay. I'm going to attack that way.
All right, go for it.
I was going to say, punch through the door. You just punch it in.
It's like those old school cartoons where just a fist comes out of nowhere. And just
poof. Like, I know you hit
19
me.
To hit.
That hits.
All right. Another 22.
He's still up, but you just hear... There's an actual humanoid scream.
Okay, good. I need him to roll a strength save.
Oh, smart! 4.
It fails.
He gets pushed, and you go through the illusionary wall.
All right. I will end my turn there.
Ooh. You said 22 points of damage, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect, perfect, perfect. Yeah, you enter in a new room. Just a collection of bodies, coffins. There's a wagon currently no longer on fire, but you see the smoke starting to be released from the crashed open window. And from the open door, you can see Savannah fighting a bunch of these crawlers. After Rolly, it's going to be this guy's turn. He's no longer suggested. He's going to growl towards you, Rolly, and he's going to take a swing with a short sword. Natural 20.
Uh-uh.
Second attack. 13 to hit.
No.
And then he's going to try to grapple and bite you. And that's going to be a 17 to hit.
No.
Woo, boy. You're a C bump. Such a great use. You take 12 points of slashing damage, reduced to half. You take 6. Because you are raging. That actually upsets me. I rolled a natural 20 and you took 6 points from that.
Sounds like a you problem.
God damn it. Wow. Yeah. Cool. Next is going to be the crawlers, first of all. First of all, this one emerges from here. This one emerges from here. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
Yeah, Jay.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. 5, 10, 15, 20. And it's going to start crawling and emerge from here. This one's going to try to attack you, Vera.
Okay.
Not gonna hit. This one is going to 2 attacks on you, Savannah. Only one of those are gonna hit, and you take 4 points of damage and make me a con save.
Fine, I'll do the con save. Actually, I just realized because I haven't been doing it. Dodge?
Oh yeah, you could. You take 2 points of damage instead.
19 on the con.
You are not poisoned.
Thank God.
The words of Oliver ring into your mind, Vera, that these holes need to be burned. And it is your turn.
Yeah, well, I can't fix that shit on my turn. I gotta fix myself. I'm gonna cast Cure Wounds at a 4th level.
Okay.
So I need 4d8. Oh, hi. 22 points of healing.
22 points? You heal 22 points of healing.
Bonus action, hit this one in front of me with a sword.
Make me attack.
17 plus 9.
That hits.
9 points of damage.
It's still up, but you definitely cut into one of its thighs, and it's starting to limp.
Okay.
I just free action to yell to Rolly that we need to, like, burn these holes, otherwise these things are going to keep coming out.
Can I hear her?
Yeah.
On account that I'm on the other side of the wall?
It's an illusionary wall.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
It's a pretend closet.
Pretend wall.
Oh, closet.
Savannah, what's your passive perception?
Where is it? I don't think it's that high. It is 13.
13. You can hear Vera yell, burn the holes.
Burn the holes? What holes?
But it's your turn, Savannah.
Well, now they're both in the wagon. I need them out the wagon. So this one's the one that have either of them been attacked already? No, right?
This one has.
This one has. Yeah. All right. So distract with mage hand and then swipe.
Go for it.
That is going to be 18 to hit.
18 hits. And you get to add sneak attack because you're doing it with advantage.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I still have all the d6. So 7. That is going to be 18 points of damage.
You. And it falls.
Are you spawn's action? All right, I'll just get ready for that one. So I'll end my turn there.
Okay. This Genesis member is going to once again repeat what he did last time. Bring out his short sword and that's going to be a 18 and a 12 for the sword attacks. 18, I believe, hits. And then for the bite, he's going to get a 21. So Rolly, I can get rid of all of the blank. Okay. First sword swing, you take 6 reduced to 3. You take 3 points of slashing damage. And now, you take 5 points of necrotic damage as his teeth sink into your side.
Oh, this guy's so dead.
As he releases, you just see, and a little bit of his wounds start to heal.
Yeah, you enjoy it, buddy.
After Genesis, the crawler's turns. This one's going to move towards you. This one's going to move to you. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Yeah. And then 5, 30. So first attack on Vera. On him. That's a miss. Next one on Rolly. That's a miss. Disadvantage through the window for Savannah. That's going to be a miss as well. And the one right in front of Savannah. That's a miss as well. I've been rolling bad on these guys. Vera, you're up.
I know. That's what I was thinking right now. Well, even if I move, I'm going to get an opportunity attack because I don't want to waste my action. I can't, like, bonus action first. I have to take my action first.
Can you bonus action what?
First.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Which one did I hit with the sword first?
This
that one,
one?
Okay. I'm going to try and hit him, try and take him out first.
Go ahead.
19?
19 hits. This guy has very little health. Let's see if you can top it.
7 points of damage.
That's what you needed.
Oh, yeah. 7 points of damage.
This one gets cut as this bright solar sword cuts through.
All right. That was going to pull in a section. And I haven't gone through the wall yet, right?
No, but you can step through it and still be within melee range.
I'm saying that for the torches. Because I know there's torches on the other side. Vera doesn't know that.
You stick your head through the legendary wall and you can see that there is a torch not but 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 feet away from you. It acts like a normal torch, but it does have a secondary property that steals radiant energy.
I don't get disadvantage if I Sacred Flame the one in front of me, right?
Sacred Flame is radiant energy.
Mm-hmm.
It is not actual fire.
Okay. No, I know, but there's no more torches in here.
Oh, in your room?
Yeah.
Correct.
So that's why I want to know if, like, if I just try a cantrip on him.
No, if you roll an AC of 5, meaning I think you can't miss unless you get a natural 1, you can burn up this hole.
Okay. He needs to make a dex save, though. It's not a hit. It's a... He needs.
Are you aiming to hit...
Him.
Him. You're trying to hit him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me make a dex save. An 8.
Yeah. 17. We're level 13 now, so this is 3d8 radiant.
3d8. Let's see if you can hit the lucky number.
Hear that, dice? You need to hit the lucky number. So far, so good. 14 points of damage?
He's still up. Barely. Just the radiant energy starts to flash him with this divine energy.
Okay. I'm going to stay right there because I'm going to try and close up this damn hole my next turn, but I'll stay right there.
Okay. After that, Savannah, you're up.
Yeah, we'll dip rid of him first. Attack the guy in front of me. Mage hand, swipe.
Got it.
That's going to be 14 to hit.
Let me double check.
I think that's too low.
14 is exactly what you needed.
Oh, yay!
Ooh. These guys aren't really wearing armor.
Their skin's their armor.
11... That's going to be 21 points of damage.
Yeah, you actually cut underneath the jaw and come almost like shut it close as your mage armor pulls back, distracting it as it drops to the floor. There's just bodies piled all over here.
I have a question, mostly for my next turn, though. Should I just wait for then?
What's your question?
How long would it take me to ransack this trailer?
I'll say 2 actions.
Okay.
You could do it quickly in 2 actions, or you can take some time and it'll be done fully. But
something tells me quickly, so we'll get there when we get there.
Got it. Roll, you're up.
Okay, well, course of action. Attack the guy at the front.
Got it.
Uh, 13 to hit.
13 does not hit. You want to reckless?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
Alright, I'll reckless. I should have said that before, but
no worries, yeah. I'll give it to you. So go ahead and try it once more.
Okay. Alright, that'll be a lot better. 24 to hit.
That hits.
Alright. Oh, that's max damage on the D12.
Hey.
24 points of damage total.
Okay. He's looking really bad. Yeah, you cut him quickly. Like an eyes wide open, almost like he was healing, feeling good about himself, and immediately you cut him back down to size, and he's starting to bleed profusely.
And now you took my blood, and I want it back. All right. Second attack.
You have advantage because you're doing it recklessly?
Yeah. 21.
That hits.
Uh, 15 points of damage this time.
How do you want to do this?
I want to do something. I can't see him, right?
You can see him.
He's invisible? Oh, I can see him.
Yeah, he's not invisible.
Okay. Rather than cleaving him, I'd like to actually impale him with the axe.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you do that thing where you crouch down low And as he's ready to swipe upwards, you move too quickly, your body too focused and formed, as you get the top of the axe and swing upwards, using the entirety of the axe's flat end, but the actual point cuts into his stomach, lifts him up about 3 feet, and as you stand, you bring him up the entirety of your height, as he is just like, no way could he reach you, and his light, you see the light in his eyes start to dim.
As they start to dim, I say, no one takes my blood. And I watch him die.
Just down.
Then I do that, you know, I do that typical, like, video game move where I just, like,
yeah,
like, literally knock him off by just flicking the axe.
He lands. Is that your turn? Any movement?
Yeah, I'm gonna go help my buddy over here. There's no wall in front of me, right?
No, you can move.
Okay. Let's see. Oh, wait, there we go. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. I'll get right there. I'll help my buddy. Hey, buddy!
Can I take a free action to yell at Rolly?
Yeah.
I need you to keep them out the trailer.
Okay.
Okay, fine.
that was your movement. All right. It is now not the Genesis members. They're all done. Let's see. How many crawlers do we have now? 1, 2, 3.
Too many.
Crawlers start to emerge.
Of course they do.
Too many.
There. Here. 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 And here. At the end of that turn, Vera, you can hear the sounds of horses.
About time, fucking Daryl.
You can hear the sound of horses, and you can hear yells. As you hear a familiar voice go, "Towards the side! Towards the side, men!" As we're going to do a theater of mine at this point, guys.
Yeah.
So Daryl is right, because I don't have an icon for him. But Daryl and a bunch of domain guards have arrived off to the side. They see the one that has just emerged. One of the guards with a spear goes, "Creatures! What was he? He was just like, I think he was just a captain. He's like, Captain, there's a creature!" And he's like, "Dispatch them quickly!" As they all start to gang up on the one closest, this one drops. Daryl walks in, sees you, Vera, and goes, "How many more?"
"A lot, and if you don't put a fire in those damn holes, they're gonna keep coming out."
"Burn the holes, men!" As they start to spread into the space. I think the only point of keeping this initiative counter going is, Savannah, I know you're trying to do something before the feds get here. So what we're gonna do is, Vera, we're gonna move very quickly.
Okay.
Are you trying to remove the one that's closest to you, or are you trying to do something else?
I'm trying to remove the one that's closest to me.
Okay, we're going
to
say you kill one of them quickly.
Okay.
The equivalent of your sword, along with some magic or your weapon. It goes down. Savannah, it is your turn. You can use your action to investigate.
I'm using my action to investigate.
Go ahead and do so.
Be nice. 18?
18. Let me see here. You find a series of notes. You're not going to have time to like look at what you find yet. You find something, put it into your bag.
Just take it all.
So,
I'm more concerned about two things. One, I want to find evidence for us. I also want to make sure that my little Thieves Clan's not really mentioning out there.
I don't think you'll have time to see that. So what's going to happen is this.
Can I just like...
First, write this down. You take a pile of notes.
Pile of notes.
Second, you see a half-burned document. So write down half-burned document. Next, you see what looks like to be almost like a... what would I call this? Like, call them task notes. Task notes. And then have... The last thing you find is write down report. You quickly grab all this into your bag. You can use your next action to investigate the already burned char remains of things, but you're only going to get like almost no information, just very little.
I don't even think the chars are worth it.
Up to you.
I mean, they burned them for a reason. Question is why?
I'm true. All right, I'll use my action to do that.
Okay.
My next action to do that.
You've done that. Rolly, you are currently guarding Savannah. Do you want to take out this guy right next to you?
Yeah, I would like to take out that guy right next to me.
All
right,
we're not going to roll. Easily enough done. You kill this guy. You can still hear the sound of echoing sounds of more crawlers coming. Back to the top, or at least the end of the round.
Real quick, can you mark where the carriage is? Point to it?
The carriage?
Yeah, the carriage.
The
thing with the evidence?
You're standing in it.
Oh, I'm standing in it. Perfect. Okay, so I'll stand side to side with Savannah.
Beautiful. Perfect. At the end of the round, Daryl's man starts to spread out. This hole is burned. This hole is burned, so we have two of them already starting to be put out. So this one. You can hear screams and sounds of battle happening within the into the actual offices of the post office.
I keep wanting to call it UPS, but we're not affiliated, yeah. So no.
Daryl's starting to make his way to you, Vera. So Savannah doesn't know this, but she's got only like one more round.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what's in there, but I mean, like, I seen Rolly go through the wall, so I would lead him through the wall.
Vera, it's your turn. Would you like to go through the wall?
Yeah, I'm just going to tell him to follow me.
Perfect. You walk through. You see one creature to the right of you and a hole.
Okay. I will sacred flame the hole.
All right, you. The hole is burnt.
I mean, if sacred flame the hole, bonus action, hit Demi.
Oh, yeah. All right. You do that. The creature is dispatched with your spiritual weapon. Savannah, roll me another investigation check.
Be nice. We'll roll lucky on that.
There you go.
22.
That's really good.
It magically reassembles itself.
On shards. I get 22 on the shards.
I'm going to roll me a d20, Savannah, just to see what you might get.
Hey, man, what if it says the line, I did it, and then signed?
15?
13.
You're going to get this piece of information and this piece of information. You pull two scraps of burnt papers and you put them away. So go ahead and mark in that you have two times burnt scraps.
Times two. Got it.
Okay. And you feel fairly confident that this is the only things you'll be able to get from this trailer. And we're going to go and count this as the end of combat. As the rest of the domain guards start to burn the holes, kill what remaining creatures they can find. Yes.
Question. Because it's on my mind. Do I see a scrying mirror similar to the one that, what's her name, had?
No. I think, because you rolled a pretty high arcana earlier on, you get a sense that Oliver already has the scrying spell.
Got it.
Yeah. We are out of initiative, everyone. And we're going to go ahead and take a 10-minute break. Give you guys some time to
breathe,
decompress. You are standing in this horrific, body-filled secret warehouse within the post office as Daryl's men start to surround the space, look for any other remaining individuals that they need to question or help. And they're currently just securing the post office. And Daryl kind of walks to you guys, goes, "You certainly can't keep yourself out of trouble."
"I didn't start this trouble."
"I'm kidding. You guys did well to tell me. Thank you." "All right, need some water?"
some. I think I need a
drink. Need a drink.
I can't drink. I'm on the clock.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I'm not clocked in on the domain's clock, though.
Good point. We'll take some time. I'm going to have the rest of the men look around, and we'll debrief. Okay?
Well, the workers did say their boss was acting weird.
Give me some moment. I have to connect with my men, okay?
No, I know. I'm just going to say
Reconvene somewhere else?
No. I want to talk to you now. Just stay here, relax for a second. And he turns around. And we'll return after our 10-minute break.
Like, don't we have a drink in Savannah?
And we're back as our heroes have covered in what looks to be like ichor and dried blood, currently standing wounded, licking their wounds as they're currently sitting within the Alrak post office as numerous domain guards are currently investigating, clearing the space, making sure everyone's all right, tending to the wounded, until finally Daryl, sort of the captain of this little troop, kind of heads back to you guys and goes, honestly, I don't even wish I had your life. You have friends that are currently locked up. You fight on this, whatever monsters these things were. You all right?
I just pull out the bottle.
Yeah, I just take a swig out of Savannah the bottle.
Fair.
And I'll say, to answer your question, that depends if you're referencing are we okay physically or are we okay emotionally.
Mentally, it's going to be a no.
I can't help on that second
physically,
one.
Physically, I've
honest.
Had better.
Well, rest up. That was intense.
Point is, we were right.
You are right. What does that mean?
Well, the queen wanted us to produce proof that it was the Blakes. And she goes like this.
All right.
And we seen him, but he kind of teleported the hell out of here.
Okay. Well, let me look around. And he starts to look around. He sees bodies. He sees coffins. He sees moved over boxes that are just like stationery and other post office necessities, walking towards the wagon beyond the illusionary wall, and just sees a charred remains of papers and scraps, and goes, not really in terms of evidence, I think.
Oh, I have some of that for you, and you also may want to bring in somebody by the name of Dallas Killian, since he likes to run.
Okay. I think I do remember a Dallas Killian.
It's the Library of the Cauldron and Claw.
Private. One of the other guys sort of stands still, and he goes, go put out an order for Dallas Killian. Bring him to, well, I guess to the station.
He was with us, but I told him he could either help us fight or run, and he decided to be a worm and run.
He was our lead here.
Yeah.
I see. All right. Well, if he is your evidence, then that is good. But since we don't have him here, I can't really say that this was caused by the queen. Or the your Blake people.
We still have to go do an interview. Vera, why don't we go do that and then we'll bring what we have.
We have paperwork that, let's just say, implicates him in a certain way.
I see. Oh, you're talking about
Kitty.
Yep. You think I was giving that back to him? Nope.
Tell you what. Go ahead and if you have anything else planned for today, rest up, I would recommend. If you have anything else planned, that's fine. We'll put out an order to find Mr. Killian.
Yeah,
and we'll bring him down.
You were going to meet us at the blacksmith's house.
Yes, if you'd like to. You can still interview the witness.
Maybe after a break.
Yeah, take your time.
Break.
Goodness me. He sort of like shakes his head, sort of puts out a stance that you all kind of turns around, talks to the rest of the group he's with, and they start to clear out slowly, starting to spread out through the city to look for Dallas.
I was like, can we get a ride back to the books and proof?
Do you want
a
ride?
Yes, please.
We have a cart. Feel free to jump in.
Jumps an understatement. It's just like waddles in there.
You get it. You're actually sitting with like two other people. It's sort of like that one of those long people moving carts. Yeah. It's like a bench on each side. As you sort of get in, especially Rolly, as he gets in, the cart kind of kind of shifts a little bit, but it stabilizes. A lot of the troops there go, whoa, okay. You see a younger looking troop, sort of a guard who, younger face, pale skin, skinny face, you know, skinny body, kind of like a newbie here, kind of just like awkwardly looks at you all and goes, what's like the scariest thing you fought?
First day on dead guy duty, huh?
I think he just wants stories, Vera.
What? Yeah, what?
Why do you like gore? Are you like big? What are you looking for?
Big? What's the biggest?
I think the giant?
Yeah, I think really? The fire giant. Or,
You mean the clan of fire giants?
A clan of fire? Or, you kind of nudges.
Clan?
What's his name? What the hell? The mutated giant with the...
Remember the god genie? I remember the god genie.
I don't know what was bigger, though.
It feels like the giant might have been the biggest thing.
It's a genie that can literally stop you from breathing with a flip of its wrist.
I mean, we also had the sea creature. I don't know if that's bigger.
Yeah, I think maybe the Leviathan was pretty big.
You see, he nudges one of his friends, and he goes, fucking Leviathan. He goes, shut the fuck up. They're telling stories. We don't know if they're right.
You don't want any of that.
Do we have proof of any of our fights on us? I'm surprised. Never mind. Hmm. You don't want to deal any of that.
One of the older ones kind of like looks at you and goes, they're great stories, really.
They're not just stories. Trust me, I wouldn't be this fucked up in the
head.
You
fought a Leviathan.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't you eat some of it, Rolene?
No, oh, it was delicious. I banished it. I had to summon the Leviathan meat because it got mad.
The younger guy sort of just brings out a little notepad and starts to draw.
Oh, you're an artist.
Kinda. I just draw here and there.
I might potentially have a job for you.
Oh, I mean, I'm more of a like a reference. People give me descriptions of people, and I try to.
Oh, like you sketch the criminals.
Might have a job for you. If you're interested in making some more gold, swing around by the Books and Brew.
Maybe after my shift.
No problem, whenever!
Not after your shift. How about we talk about this job after this comes down?
I was gonna say, why don't we just pay him to sketch Ollie so they now know what he looks like?
That is true.
Well, that is secondary to what I was talking about, but yes!
Sure.
Can I, like, just describe Oliver Rolling to him as we're riding back?
If you can. Roll me a performance check.
Well, I'm not drawing it. Can I give myself guidance?
Sure. But this is going to be your description. How descriptive can you be?
That is not very... Oh, good. D4. Oh, yeah, man, I rolled pretty good. I don't think my performance is much of anything, but let's see. It's just a plus one. Performance plus one, but 18 plus four is 22, so 23.
He looks to you, Rolly, and goes, by the way, I'm Jackson.
Nice to meet you.
Rolly, Savannah, Viva, pleasure.
No, we kind of heard about you all. Griffins. Oh,
good things, I hope.
Yeah, you guys kind of went towards the mirror bite, cleared that out. Yeah, that's... Wow.
You know, Mirabai is where we found that genie.
He kind of looks towards the older guy. He's like, did we find a genie?
Oh, of course you didn't find the genie. We ended it.
And the other one, yeah, they ended it.
Don't worry. I'm pretty sure Ruby Blair has a report on that one, but I don't think it's well-known knowledge.
He starts to draw by your description, Vera. And he does draw a fairly good reference. You know, he kind of gets the chin a bit wrong. Ears are a little bit more pointed. Like, he's not an elf, so you're like, no, you have to erase that. So he sort of puts it more of a humanoid rounded ear. But he's fairly, could be used as a wanted poster if needed.
That's pretty close.
You want it?
Can you make copies of it?
we do have a print shop.
Make copies of it, because you would want to know what he looks like if you ever see him. He's a pain in the ass.
Okay.
Rightly so.
I'll ask Daryl if that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. I hear Daryl, who's sort of in the front, going, "It's fine. Just go ahead and do it." All right. Thank you, Captain. Sure. Yeah, we'll make that done. And it's not too long until finally the cart stops. All right. Books and Brew.
Thank you. I just hop out of the...
We'll be in touch.
I hope so. Enjoy the winter evening.
I hurry up and go inside.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. You close the door behind you. Still the empty coldness of the Books and Brew. However, there's a little bit more warmly because Mary is still there. And she's currently cooking something up right now.
Oh, thank God.
Oh, hello.
It's a nice change.
I hope this was fine. I ended up taking care of a couple of things.
You're fine. Trust me, it's welcome.
It is highly appreciated, too. Thank you.
I have an odd question. You're the only one here, right?
Yes. Yeah.
I quickly start unpacking my bag.
Just a bunch of ash starts to be spread.
Sorry if you cleaned.
I did, but it's fine. I have to keep myself busy.
Sorry, guys. I just couldn't let the law enforcement people get a hold of this first.
Well, we told them we had stuff to compile, and they knew we had free reign, so it's not like it was anything out of the ordinary.
So the only question I have with this, Savannah, is if you didn't give law enforcement a chance to find this, and then we use it, wouldn't that make us guilty of obstructing justice?
I gotta just give Rolly the look like, do I look like I care?
I mean, technically, I didn't know she had it. Did you, Rolly? Did you know she had it? And
he was in the room when I took it. He was in the room when I took it.
I mean, Your Honor, I have no knowledge of this. I mean, I honestly do challenge its legitimacy because it was never presented in court as a proper piece of evidence.
See, I'm not Steven. Rolly, you witnessed the crime. You didn't report the crime. You had a chance to turn me in, but you didn't.
I don't know of this. This is news to me now, Your Honor. I have no knowledge of any of this.
What is it saying?
Are you
going
to turn me in? I'm looking at Rolly. I'm like, are you going to turn me in?
The authorities are on their way as we speak.
Anyways, I go start looking through. Where's my little sticky? I start going through. Wrong sticky. Sorry, I typed everything on a quick sticky note.
No worries.
We'll go through the pile of notes first.
The pile of notes, the first thing you find is using the notes and blackmailing letters that you got from Dallas's room, you're able to construct a full conversation between Dallas and these blackmailers who you now know to be the Genesis members, or Oliver directly. It reads, do they know it's all copper, Mr. Killian? Response, what do you want? We just want to place an order, Mr. Killian. Who are you? What do you want? What type? Just two things, Mr. Killian. A vial and a little special gift. And that's where the conversation ends. You get a sense that probably there was more, but it got burnt.
And that was from the pile of notes, or that was like, you said that was from the scraps of paper?
That was from the pile of notes, yes.
Pile of notes, okay. Half-burned docs.
It's difficult to read exactly what it says, but one word strikes you hard, and it is a description of a location called Flint Castle.
Craft notes.
You find notes given, like, it was meant to be given to Dallas. It was given to Dallas, but this is like a copy of it, of specific requests in terms of a new crafted item. A kind of wand that allows one to infuse unstable smith spells into a simple, unexpected wand.
Okay. And report?
Report. You essentially glean what looks to be a small like a document that I'll give a summary of essentially what it says is, talks with Zygthmoy has improved. She's now more eager than ever to enter the material plane after having a slight taste back in Arrowfield.
Then, I guess what's left is the two scraps of paper.
The first scrap reads, "I can't believe the good doctor has escaped our radar." And the last one reads, like, it's almost like burnt halfway through a sentence, and it reads, "Move and transfer to my queen. I hope she enjoys them."
So the good news, sounds like we have the other half of those letters. I don't know where the hell Flint Castle is. Wand infused Smith with Smith cells. That's not the first time we've encountered that, is it? And this is me talking out loud to Rolly and Vera.
I don't think it was a wand. Lily just did them.
Someone had a wand, didn't they?
No, like I know how to do a Smith spell. I mean, Igno might.
Let's see, we have the report that can't say name out of my mouth right now.
Zygmunt.
It's trying to enter the. Zygmunt is trying to enter the material plane, and
what was the last part of the scraps? I got the doctor.
Moved and transferred to my queen. I hope she enjoys them.
Do you think that's in reference to Queen Evergrey?
Probably.
Unless there's someone bigger.
Well,
I'm kind of relieved there's no mention of the Raven's Kiss in there, so I feel better on that.
It's probably with Olivia.
This is true. I'm going to take the second half of the letters and put them with the letters that we have from Dallas and just kind of put them all together.
Perfect. Yeah, you make a comprehensive conversation between the two.
Flint Castle. Do we know where Flint Castle, or have we heard of Flint Castle?
I think even with a history check, I don't think any of you all have heard of Flint Castle.
I'll try a history check.
I said even with a history check, I don't think you'd
Hey,
be
Mary, do you know what Flint Castle is?
That might be an Igno or Roman question. It's like, what's Flint Castle?
Mary places down a plate of what looks to be like yesterday's steak, cooked up with a bit of gravy and a side of potatoes, and slides it all to all three of you and goes, "I'm sorry, dear. I don't know what that is."
It's all right. Maybe my dad might know because he's really old. Thank you. Sorry we made the kitchen a mess after you cleaned it.
Oh, no, no. Again, I need time to I gotta keep my mind busy.
I mean, if this goes over well, hopefully they'll let Moscow out.
Oh, let me go ahead and correct one thing for you, Savannah. This is my mistake. Not Flint, Flit. F-L-I-T.
F-L-I-T?
Yeah. I-T, okay.
No N, my apologies. But as you mentioned that to Mary, she goes, "I don't know a Flit Castle, but, I mean, Flit? Kind of, it means move swiftly."
Hey, Mary, you said you knew Dallas?
No, Moscow used to tell me stories when we were first dating.
Oh. Mm.
She said he knew Moscow.
Moscow knows Dallas.
Yeah.
Interesting character.
He may want to unknow Dallas after this.
Okay.
Listen, he didn't seem like a bad guy, but the wrong person used the proper leverage, and now he's not a nice guy. And it made Moscow look bad.
Goodness, the company that man keeps.
He tries to be friends with everybody. That doesn't mean they all want to be friends with him.
True. Well, enjoy your food.
Thank you. How are you doing, by the way? We didn't really ask you.
you can see her immediately starting to clean whatever dishes are there, and almost re-cleaning dishes. She goes, fine.
Uh-huh. That's the same plate, Mary.
Right. I'll put it away.
I think I just put my hand on her shoulder. Like, we're gonna fix it eventually.
No, I know. She sort of puts a hand on your hand. I know. Just... it's a lot.
Yeah, that's for sure.
I think that's our slogan, is it's a lot.
Yeah, I'm... okay, I'm gonna go to the second floor and clean up there, too, and I know you have work to do. Call me if you need me.
Just if you hear us leave for any reason, we'll probably tell you we're leaving. Just make sure you lock the door.
Oh, I have.
Okay.
She waves to you all, goes into the elevator, goes to the second floor.
That woman looks a nervous wreck.
She's had a hard time.
I mean, wouldn't you be a wreck if someone dear and near to you was imprisoned for something that you would never think he'd done before?
No, I just have an entire clan of Kanku who can't talk.
And aren't you a nervous wreck?
Yes, really. Yes.
Then there you go! I completely understand. This must be a really hard time for her. And you, of course.
Speaking of which, Rolly, have you heard anything from your family yet?
I have not, but I do not really have a way to get in touch with them.
Are we taking a long rest or a short rest?
Actually, why don't we just go downstairs and see if anyone's there?
Oh,
we
yeah.
can actually check in and see if Richard got back.
Gonna say, because I'm a little tapped on the messaging.
Fine, I'll hop in the elevator and to say the password to go down to the Raven's Kiss.
You head down. There are about three random members here who kind of sparsely make their way here at times, talking amongst themselves. One of them has sort of appointed themselves, sort of this half-elf woman who is just sort of appointed herself to be sort of the bartender, as there is no Richards in sight. And she goes, greetings. Kind of sparse right now in terms of jobs, but... oh! Hello, agent?
No, Richard?
Are you privy to the going-ons?
Never mind, I just walked to the back.
Okay. You kind of walk back. Yeah, there's the teleportation circle, but there is no Richards back there. Funny thing that you mentioned that, too. I had this planned. Vera, you get a messaging spell. Let's see here. Where did I put it? Apologies. Oh, here it is. Vera, it's your father.
Uh-oh.
I am here with the Barnwells now. Are we expecting the attack soon? It's been a day or so, and we haven't seen anyone. My platoon keeps watch.
We try to call it off, but I don't know if they'll make it in time. I'm glad everybody's okay. I would still keep watch. It's only been a short time. Be careful. I mean, if she's sitting next to Rolly, Rolly probably hears her say that. He says that he has... about my dad says that he's there with your family, that he hasn't seen anybody, that everything seems okay for now. So maybe Richard got to them. I don't even know if Steve heard that.
You didn't? Wait, what?
Sorry. Diddly daddly.
I said your family's fine. Nothing's happened yet.
Oh, thank God. Okay, good. Good.
Hopefully Richard...
I owe your family a many things. A many things.
I just told him to stay there, that it's only been 24 hours. I don't know if Richard actually called it off or was able to call it off.
Well, I mean, as long as your family's there, I think I'll be... it'll ease my mind a bit. to be okay.
Yeah.
I am placing a very heavy, you know, I'm definitely placing a very huge, you know, amount of hope on them. So I really is a little bit nervous about this whole thing, but it does ease his mind to know that they're okay.
I'm kind of glad that your younger brother's not there. That's all he needs.
I mean, for once, Rolly's actually like, you're probably right. It's probably a good thing. He doesn't need to see all this, doesn't need to be worried. I guess maybe he can be, maybe he can move himself forward with this, even though I would have wished it were something else. But if the boy's got a curiosity, magical, so be it, right? What am I to stop him?
Who knows? It might be a big help later.
Red hindrance.
He'll be fine. He's not.
Look at A-Rad.
A-Rad! Yeah, but Cat's a lot different than A-Rad. You know that.
I hope so. I mean, he's only a boy. We don't really know yet.
Savannah, you go to the back. Still seeing that there has been any notice of, like, returns or details, but you're in the back of a bar, you grab a few bottles.
Just because habits. I'll go back to the barkeep. Obviously, I don't recognize, and she made a comment that makes me think she does not know who I am, so I'll go to her. Hello.
Hello.
So, how have you been managing on jobs? I'm assuming there hasn't been any jobs.
Very little. Last thing we had on our docket is to find out what happened to the fallen or rejected domain. Yeah. Chosen. That's currently on standstill. We have agents out in the field waiting for that, but we need a direction, a voice. Usually this comes from Richard. She kind of looks at the symbol that you have, marking you as an agent, goes, if you have any requests, we can put jobs out.
I mean, right now, middle of two different things. I do want to know a follow-up on a job we did put out for a cancellation of a hit.
Oh,
So, yes. Do we know if that was did anything from that?
She pulls out a ledger. She kind of thumbs through and she goes, do you know what branch this was put in?
Wait.
Wherever Temple Leon was.
Okota.
So it would be the Okota one.
Got it.
I'm like, wait.
Starts to go through it. Yes, an individual named Anne. Accepted the offer, or no, I think that was the one that placed the offer.
Yeah.
We had two agents accept it. However, it has been marked as canceled.
Oh, thank God.
I'm unsure if this has been reached towards the two agents or the two members, but definitely if it has been canceled, individuals have been sent to find them.
That's still ongoing. Oh, thank you.
Of course. Of course, we were swiftness, so hopefully it's cancelled quickly. Or these members know it's cancelled quickly.
Yeah, I'm gonna go back upstairs. I'm like, thank you, just walk upstairs.
Of course. You return back. At this point, it's about a little past midday. The sun is currently kind of around 2 p.m., 2 or 3.
Oh, I'm going to go take my shield outside and fucking charge it, because apparently I got to go do that.
It's during dawn.
Ah, okay, never mind.
Are we going to go do the interview today, or are we really just going to... Oh, by the way, brought bottles up. Are we going to go do the interview today, or are we going to rest?
I'd like to get them out.
Yeah, but
I can still make him tell the truth. I have
two more days, guys. This is counted as one of them, too.
I think we're going to need our full strength, though, just in case.
I can technically do a long rest in 4 hours and then go interview him. If it's, like, noon now, it'd be, like, around afternoon. I mean, like, 5 p.m. definitely.
How long will it take you to take a short rest?
Short rest, I won't get anything back. Doesn't do anything other than hit points.
I don't work that way.
A part of me is wanting to go do the interview just to get out the way. A part of me is the Blakes are still out there. We don't need to be caught again. And they're scrying on us, so the moment we walk out of this bar, we're going to be spotted.
That and just
they
like...
they could be scrying on us right now.
They may not be able to in here.
Wards, I mean, really, we have wards. I hope they're working.
But, like Dallas, they could have put a symbol on that guy, and if he talks... explosion.
I mean, we stopped it once.
When I had enough spell slots, we stopped it once. I mean, I'm fine with resting for a few hours and then going back out, but...
So what's the plan, guys?
I think we're gonna take the rest.
Take a 4-hour rest? Or are you guys spent the night and that's it?
I think we'll spend the night. Okay. And then I'll do a spell before I sleep.
Got it. What's that spell?
Sending. Gonna have to send it at like a really high level because I'm out.
Since we have like a small little library, can I like kind of research through our library, see if I could feel like something of Flit Castle?
Yeah, go ahead and roll me a history check. Using the books at the Books and Brew.
That's gonna be a 14.
14. Yeah, a lot of the books that you have are kind of new releases, you know, things that are fairly popular, things where if someone wanted to sit down, have some tea or coffee and drink and read, they can. You get a sense that the knowledge you're trying to look for is something historic, something older than the books you currently have. Vera, you send a sending spell to who?
I'll go outside if this is going to get negated.
No, we ruled that you get this from the inside.
I'm going to send a message to Daryl. I'm going to tell him that we're going to rest for the night, given what's happened today. We'll meet up at the witness's house in the morning, like around 9-ish.
Okay. You get a response. Not a problem. Totally understandable. We'll have a carriage waiting for you 9-ish then.
Sweet. I don't have to walk.
All right. And she's just gonna go, like, collapse in a corner. But I think Vera is gonna take, like, some kind of watch once her 4 hours are up, just because she doesn't trust nothing anymore.
Is there anything you guys would like to do or say or prep while you're spending the rest of the day here? Because it's around 2 p.m. now. You're gonna spend the rest of the day hanging out within the Books and Brew and just sort of relaxing.
I mean, I'll help Sav, like, we'll organize the notes and stuff just so it makes sense for when we present it.
Okay. If there's nothing, guys, you guys take a long rest.
Jeez.
It is the next day, and you have the remainder of this day to collect your evidence and continue investigation, as tonight is the trial.
I tell them that the Daryl's bringing a carriage so we don't have to walk.
Nice.
Not too long until you hear an ethereal knock at the door.
Come in. I think Vera's just brewing coffee.
Daryl walks in and goes, familiar scent once again. I'm fine this time, thank you. You didn't offer. Anyways,
well,
we have...
You sure?
I'm fine.
I'll give you a spoon. Sorry. And everything.
Oh, fancy.
Very fancy. No. The carriage is ready whenever you're done with your breakfast. I would recommend hurrying up, though.
It's a liquid breakfast. I'll be fine.
Perfect. I know that feel. I'll be outside.
Are we ready?
I think so.
Okay, go on out.
You go into the cart.
I say bye to Mary and tell her to lock the door.
Of course, yeah. She starts to clean, locks the door behind you. As you start to make your way into the cart heads down, and you are led towards one of these like curved space, where, like it's like a street that starts to curve around what looks to be a gigantic tree that grows. It's covered in snow and red leaves, and sitting within its numerous large branches is a small little house that is almost like an L where it's connected downwards. And it's a little leathersmith shop called the Straps Scraps.
I was like, Straps Crap? That's
no,
sad. Straps,
Daryl gets out of the carriage, opens the door, and goes, the witness is named Lambert, or Mr. Whitbottom, if you'd like to call him. He's upstairs. He's very compliant, which I've very helpful with this investigation. Honestly, think he just wants to get the limelight. I don't know, but I'll be right here outside the door when you are ready to finish your investigation. One moment, me, Mr.
I whispered the bear, I'm like, limelight. So this may be really be nothing.
Mr. Whitbottom, we have your a secondary. Line of questionings, and you hear, "Oh, good!" And the door, "Hello!" And you see what looks like to be a kind of a middle-aged man, a gnome individual with these large pointed ears, dirty blonde hair, a little bit more on the blonde side that goes down to his about his chin. He has these large mutton chops that go down to his cheeks that are almost pulled back. He's wearing. Even though it's really early in the morning, he's wearing like a puffy shirt with a bright blue jacket that goes down to what looks to be navy pants. And he's not wearing any shoes. You just see sort of the tufts of hair on his feet. And he's like, come on in. Come on. Are you the special agents?
Something like that.
Oh, good. He closes the door and you're led into a leathersmith shop. And he's like, come upstairs. I'll have some tea ready for you all. Ask me anything. Oh boy, they're certainly gonna have my name in the paper. I'm gonna help out with this case.
I was gonna ask Daryl before he leaves us if he wanted to be witness to what this guy says, other than just us three.
Oh, I'd be honored. I wasn't sure if you wanted to handle it your way or not, but yes.
Oh, I'm gonna handle it my way, but I'd rather there be a person that isn't from our group here, so that when we present it, it isn't like, well, only us three.
Sounds like a plan. Kind of walks with you. Good. More eyes. More eyes. Oh. Well, he starts to hand you cups. He's like, and they're like cracked and chipped. Kind of hands you what he can. He goes, it's an old set. Don't worry about it. Yes. How can I help?
You seem like, willing. Do you mind if I do a... something to help you remember the truth?
Of course I'd be more than willing.
Okay. Vera will cast truth telling on him.
Zone of truth?
Yeah, zone of truth. Sorry.
The zone. I don't think you can select one person, can you?
I think I can select an area. Hold on.
Okay. Yeah, we'll say that you select an area just where it affects him. He gives in.
15-foot radius, so I can put it like around him in a certain position.
Yeah, he gives into the spell.
That's why I asked first. Because I was like, I don't want this dude just to be a...
Just see it. The gods already did this, so I'm used to it. I understand. Oh, Lambert Whitbottom. Crack. Witness to the case.
I also have that ring of truth-telling. That's what I was getting confused. For insight checks advantage. What did you, or who did you see exactly the night of?
Well, it was a dark and stormy night. And you hear the Daryl in the back. It was dark, little rainy, not really stormy. Well, it was stormy to me. All right.
Can't lie, technically.
No, but he's basically, like, that's his interpretation.
Of a storm.
Yeah. All right, fine. It was a cold and frigid night. Well, I was simply moving some equipment back to the outdoor storage area downstairs, and I heard a frightful sound. Like the sound of an ear-shattering scream. Well, I mean, I got a little curious, and I made my way up the hill. I looked down an alley where I saw the Books and Brew. Been there myself, place. Where I heard yelling. And I saw that bartender that works there, the one with the fiery hair. Mm-hmm. Hard to forget him. He makes very incredible drinks. And you see, no lie. Fiery hair, brightly colored clothes. And then I saw a brightly colored yellow tiefling woman, who I believe she was the cook. I don't remember, it's been a while. She stood by and watched everything. And then a black-haired woman, human, with a green dress, attacked the guards and the general. And they threw spells and daggers, and they cut her down to size. But I had to leave. I didn't want to be caught, so I ran home.
I just find it interesting that you left her there and seen it.
I didn't want to be killed. You kidding me? The general got killed. What hope do I have?
And when did you go seek help?
Who?
You didn't tell anybody that you've seen somebody murdered in the street?
No. This is a DM. Who's Kelp?
No, she said seek help.
Who's help? Okay. Oh, I did it right away. I found the nearest guard and told them.
Huh.
Of course, I ran away from the scene. I didn't want to be slayed.
I mean, it's Trezona truth, but can I do the inside check anyway?
Yeah, go for it.
It's zone of truth, though.
I don't care, man. It may be the truth as he sees it. Seven.
Go ahead.
17 plus 9, so.
26.
Yeah.
You are watching this guy. He's definitely embellishing a lot of things, but they're not lies. You know, like calling it like a super stormy night. It's like it was. I mean, it was drizzling barely and snowing. You know. But he's telling the truth to the best of the of his knowledge.
Lambert, right?
Yes.
Did you get anything interesting in the mail lately?
No. Not that I'm aware of.
Or had an interesting encounter with a stranger? Or maybe even a friend?
I mean, my friend Thomas is a very weird person. He likes to tell him that the birds speak to him. But I don't think that's relevant.
Can I try something?
I think you already have tried something. I'm open for anything.
Uh-huh. Can I try Greater Restoration on him?
You can try.
I'll use it. And I know, yes, it costs 100. I try Greater Restoration.
You place a hand on his shoulder, and the light from the room starts to flicker, and it finally starts to dim a bit as the light starts to emanate from your hand and pulling from his body. And finally you pull what looks to be a spell, and it turns to ash into your hand, and Mr. Whitbottom kind of goes,
I didn't see anything.
Everybody else see that disappear?
I did.
I didn't see anything.
I saw it.
I was home working on an order, a leathersmith order, and I heard a knocking at the door. And I opened it, and a man, a mailman, it looked to me, and that's all I remember.
You remember what he looked like?
Take the paper from Vera of the drawing. I'm like, did he look like that by chance?
That's him, yeah.
I just look at Daryl.
Well, holy shit.
Will you be able to testify that information so we can have it written down, Mr. Whitbottom?
Sure. I mean, I'm not really... I didn't really see anything, though.
You've seen a lot more than you think.
Somebody
you've seen enough.
Put a spell on you to make you convict innocent people.
Okay. And you just see, like, a bolt of confusion. Like, he never went outside. He never saw something fight.
And I just, like, help sit him down.
Okay.
Should we keep him here, or should we put him somewhere where it's safe?
I don't know. Daryl, should we bring him with us?
I'll take him with us. If you need to continue any further investigations, fine. But the trial is today. So
yeah, we could bring him.
I'm going to bring him in for an explanation.
Do you have a paper or anything with this order on it, Amber?
Yeah, of course. He kind of waves towards one of the ledgers. I'm going to tell you now as you go through it. It is a simple, like, an order for leather armor from one of the...
But does it say, like, the day?
It was placed, like, 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
He was just working on it.
I still say we bring it.
We're going to bring him, but just as a backup, and I go find a piece of paper and pen, I'm like, can you write a statement and sign the date?
Oh, of course! And he writes down, like, of sound mind and body,
Now
he starts to write down that he spent this night 2 days ago at home and was interrupted by a knock, and he saw a mailman that looked like the description of the paper given to him by these individuals, and his memory has been shoddy since then.
Daryl, you signed it too.
Yeah.
She a lawyer? How did she, where did this?
She's not stupid. Yes, she helps us run the business.
She is the financial and legal aspects of our business. This is why our business is so good.
I honestly, you're in the main circle of the castle. That doesn't surprise me. That's good. That's signs it.
Thank you,
Mr. Whitbottom. Sorry about your memory.
Oh no, it's. How many more things have I forgotten?
Do you at least know what today is?
He recounts the day.
Okay.
I just tap him on the back, like, I think I can only do the one today, but, yeah, it's not like an overall memory spell. It's just to restore what you didn't actually have.
Okay. Now I understand, Thomas.
Who's Thomas?
My friend!
Okay.
And from where? Work? Is he another blacksmith?
No, he's just a friend. I met him.
Yeah. And he talks to birds.
Oh, yeah, we have coffee all the time. We sit outside, play chess. He says the squirrels talk to him.
Uh-huh. What does Thomas look like?
And he describes, like, another gnome. Mm. Kind of a younger face.
Huh.
I'm now more curious of why they would have chose him. So you saw the mailman. Anything else happened that week that might have been out of ordinary?
I not that I can recollect now. I'm really kind of second guessing myself. I just try to make friends with everyone. I kind of recognize as much as I can, because everyone could be a friend.
When was the last time you got the books in Brew?
Oh, about 2 months ago. I had something that was called a daiquiri. It was good.
What does Thomas do, out of curiosity?
Daryl kind of leans in and goes, we have a record of Thomas. He's just sort of a nomad that... He's one of the few people who don't believe, and he sleeps in a tent outside of town.
That's still... Okay, I know we've seen some shit in the last day or so, but somebody had to keep an eye on him to put that spell.
Thomas has been watching me for 10 years? No.
I just kind of twisted it. Nomads are kind of normal here, Vera.
No, I don't think it was him. I'm just saying in general.
But so I do agree, someone had to watch him to figure out he would be a good witness. Right?
Or you're just wrong spot, wrong time.
That's true, too.
I'm only like a 2-minute walk away from the Books and Brew. I just sort of go up the hill.
So you're convenient.
Sure.
All right. Well, let's get going then. I think we're all going at this point.
Okay. We're going to call it there, guys. As I will at least ask you this, as you start to exit out of Mr. Whitbaum's establishment and home, Daryl kind of gets back into the cart and goes, "You want me to take you somewhere, or?"
Oh, we're going with you. Aren't we going to the trial?
Perfect. And you see sort of one of the other guards takes Mr. Woodbottom, sits him in the back, and goes, "Let the trial begin." And the horses start to turn and go up towards the castle. And we will pick up next week as the group tries to clear up any confusion about the fate of the Books and Brew and its employees.
Tries.
You've got some evidence. You've got some witnesses. Or at least broken some witnesses' accountings. So, yeah.
Spicy new evidence.
New evidence. We'll be live next week, guys, so check you then.
Bye.
Bye.